What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to Sundays with Steven. It's our Sunday morning live streams here on the Las Vegas Strip. Well, not really, here in Las Vegas. And today's video, we're gonna do things, starting a new format. We're gonna do some news items from the past week or things that I found interesting, followed by a walk. And the walk today is gonna take us to the oldest neighborhood in all of Las Vegas. A neighborhood where nothing is what it seems and old buildings certainly don't serve their original purpose. We're gonna look at a park that was closed down because of homelessness and is completely fenced off. We're also going to check out a theater that's on the National Historic Registry of Places, but you can't see a show there, at least not yet. It's a place that's been up and down, dilapidated, and had famous bands built by an architect that was known for building some of the most prolific theaters on the entire West Coast in cities much older than Vegas, places like San Francisco, San Diego, Los Angeles, California. And it's gonna be an interesting one. How's it going, folks? We're gonna wait till we get about 100 people, then we're gonna go through the news that I found this week to be entertaining, interesting, or things that you had asked me about. And then a little bit later, we're gonna take a walk. It's a beautiful Sunday morning. Yesterday was windy. We were in a windstorm. Wasn't all that nice, but today it is chilly for me, but it's still 53 degrees with a high of 64. Every time the winds of change come into Vegas, it gets a little bit different for the weather. If it's cold and it's windy, it'll be warm. And if it's warm and it's windy, it'll be cold. But there's no rain, so nobody complains about that. Okay, so not leaving Las Vegas, Rangers first overall. Are they really? So this is, people used to send me stuff before my P.O. box went away. This was my man out in New York. He sent me a ton of New York stuff, so I got the Knicks and the Rangers. I figured that way I looked more like a tourist. Maybe they won't be kicking me out of no hotels. We're gonna make that video on why I am never going back to the Fountain Blue ever again. That'll be this week on Thursday, so, you know, subscribe to the channel. What's up, Croak? Okay, Shane Coucheron is here. What's up, Shane? Hi, Greek couple. I met Greek couple downtown about 6 months ago, a year ago. Didn't someone get decapitated at that park? Maybe. Man, there's so much stuff I don't know. Oh man, that's terrible. If it was during COVID era, they probably said he did it, died of COVID, even though his head was severed. That security guard was hilarious at the FB on Friday. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? But Winston Churchill once said, you never let a good crisis go to waste. All right, we got 104 people. Let's talk about some news items. Let's see if I can do this. So we're gonna go in order of newest to oldest. This is a bizarre one. So we're gonna show you it here. So this is actually Prince Harry. And we're gonna have to see, we have to figure out our formats here. So this is a strange one. Prince Harry insured for $1 million at a Las Vegas strip club. This is really weird. A couple of years ago, Prince Harry came to a strip club in Vegas and he basically had nudes that weren't fully nudes. They were leaked. And I guess the strip club owner, and I'm not gonna name it, I'm not gonna give this guy free publicity. He has a pair of Prince Harry's underwear, which is really weird. And he's actually insured it for like $500,000 or $250,000. He says that he was legit. He's upped all of the security at his property. He is legitimately scared and frightened for the security of his establishment. He claims that he's worried that a group of armed thugs, like in A Clockwork Orange or something, armed with nothing more than, you know, metal bars, are gonna break in and just rough everybody up to get these things. So he's insured them for like $250,000. I don't know what he thinks they're worth, but he thinks they're worth either $250,000 or $500,000. Strange news item, and I think it's obviously just for publicity. He's just doing this to try to get free publicity for his establishment. Strip clubs in Vegas tend to pop up and disappear. There's a few older ones out there, but that's the first news update. Sports Reference, I have to call a friend. Okay, second one here, we're gonna have to bring out, oh, see, and I'm not really familiar with the format. Let's go here. And this second update comes to us here. It is Casino Royale on Las Vegas Strip could see implosion this year. So people have been asking me about Casino Royale. Is Casino Royale going away? The answer is probably not. Maybe, possibly. So pokerplayer.net, I think it was, They're a poker website, but of course they're going to talk about Vegas stuff because the World Series of Poker here happens every year. And they decided to run with this story and post it up because, again, you can attach Vegas to anything and get a whole bunch of views. And this is something that's been in the works since August of 2023. This is because the Casino Royale and the owners of it, which is Best Western, put in an application to build a big tower on the site of Casino Royale, and they only have until January of 2025 to start the development of the project, or else it goes stale. They can go to the county commissioners and ask for an extension of that permit, or they can just let it go. But it doesn't mean they're going to build anything. So now everybody's running around going, Casino Royale is closing. Not necessarily. You're going to have to keep your ear out on this one. And if you type in Casino Royale closing, this is the only thing that you find, which means that there was nothing that actually went out to the real media. And I'm not saying pokerplayer.net is not real media, but we'll get to another fake news item that happened this week where you can see that the internet allows things to spread unfairly by wildfire. Let's see here. Next one up, let's go to some of your comments before we do that there. So we have, that's the name Harry. So we're talking about Harry. Let's see here. Would love to see you do some true crimes. Lorena, yes, wife wants me to do that. I've been researching stuff. Let's see here. What do you think of the proposed A Stadium? I think it looks stupid, Marty. They want to build the Sydney Opera House, but they should just build it. Casino Royale is where you go when you need to get H word. I can't say those words because I will get myself in trouble legally. I don't know, Best Western probably has good standards. But anyways, Anthony is here from Warrington in the UK. Matt Hugh is here. Let's go to another news story here. This is the fake news story that we were telling you about just now. So this is the Bruno Mars story. So Bruno Mars, it came out, some people were claiming that Bruno Mars owes $50 million to the MGM Resorts International as casino markers that are unpaid debts. If you don't know what a casino marker is, it's literally just a loan from the casino so you can play. Frank Sinatra in the past, I'll tell you a quick story here, he was famously known for getting markers and leaving them open at the Old Sands Hotel. And then when Howard Hughes, the billionaire mogul, millionaire, but billionaire in modern days, when he purchased the Sands, they changed the rules. It was corporate rule because the Hughes Corporation owned it and they wanted to get Frank Sinatra's marker back. A marker can be worth millions of dollars for a high roller, but the casino knows that they're gonna pay eventually. But it's all fake news because Bruno Mars doesn't have $50 million in markers. This was something that was posted up on a news aggregator that I don't even pay attention to anymore because as soon as I got it, I told it my interests and then it decided to push me one-sided politics all day long, even though I did not select politics as my interest. I selected local news. It's called Newsbreak. Newsbreak, I selected just local Vegas news, and instead I'm getting things about how the economy is great and then Joe Biden this and Donald Trump's a bad orange man that, and I'm like, I don't want that. So Newsbreak, anybody can post anything on Newsbreak. I can take a video, I can make a bunch of stupid crap that doesn't even exist, and then I can put it on my blog, and then I can put it on Newsbreak. And it's a news aggregator where anybody can upload, nothing is vetted, so then at that point, all bets are off. It goes viral, and that's what happened with Bruno Mars. Bruno Mars doesn't even gamble at MGM Resorts International properties. So the story was Bruno Mars owes $50 million a year, but he's only paid $25 million a year. So he has to work for 2 years for free, not getting any money. That's not true. But I did a YouTube short on Bruno Mars. He was arrested for Coca-Cola Classic consumption, the powdered form that's white and goes up your nose. He was arrested for that in 2010, but nothing else really happened out of that. Next news item up here that I found interesting this week. This is something that I told you guys about last week. I told you about a place called the Q Club, C-U-E-C-L-U-B. We're gonna go to this on a future Sunday stream, historic commercial area near Strip targeted for improvements. This is kind of a big deal. My client at the Q Club is what they are, and I sell advertising. They're in My Vegas Magazine. That's who I work as the marketing director for. And they wanted to be in the magazine. They said there's big things happening in our area. This is that area. So we're gonna have like this little arts district that's way off, and it's not far from here, but it's down Sahara. We'll go down there on a future live stream, but I wonder what they're gonna do with the green door. What are they gonna do with the green door? Because the green door is a swingers club in Vegas. And are they gonna keep it open with this? There's also bathhouses for men in this area. Like, I'm a Christian. Like, you're gonna know my stance. So I'm not gonna preach to you about why it's good or bad. But what I'm wondering is, when the city's gonna put a bunch of money into that, do they lean on those things to disappear? Or is it truly multicultural in a European sense, where we can have the green door and adult male bathhouses and these kinds of things that are right next to where the city put a bunch of money in to put a kick-ass bakery and an amazing artist and a really cool place that makes custom soaps and this kind of stuff. So this will happen in the future. We'll go down into there and check it out as it goes. So make sure you subscribe to the channel if you're not already subscribed. Let's see here. Apparently I have a typo in the title of my video. So let's see what that typo is. Exploring the oldest and strangest part of Vegas. Sub days with Steven. Well, that's not a mistake. It's sub days because I want you to subscribe. No, it was totally a mistake. So we fixed that there. Thank you so much. A Vegas channel, you have a typo, yes. Okay. So let's go to another one here. There is a ton of people in the Pepper Club, even though it is 8:49 in the morning. So we got two more news stories to look at. Next news story is one that a lot of you guys have your finger on. Jimmy Buffett's Margaritaville is set to close on the Las Vegas Strip, might open up in a new location. Of course, you know, Margaritaville, Jimmy Buffett passed away a few years back. And this was a very, very, very popular place. Super popular. Like, this sits and has major frontage outside of the Flamingo. The Flamingo, when they renovated and did some renovations, they literally took a part of this area that I've been in on the front where the main casino floor is there, and then there was a hallway with nothing. They redeveloped that area as a bar and a casino called the Margaritaville Casino. Now Margaritaville is set to close. Some people are like, why? Why? Well, it's just because of casino leases. Hey, Jeff Shapiro subscribed. Cool. Subscribe to the Best Vegas channel. Thanks, Jeff. So it's just because of a lease. Now what happens is that, so the Flamingo is a gaming, like Caesar's Palace, Caesar's Entertainment, they're a gaming company. They are not a company that does restaurants, this, that, and the other. So, hi, how you doing? Good morning. By the way, we're here at the English Hotel, and I want you guys to know it's so gracious of them to allow us to be down here. I think that was the owner, one of them, and we'll talk about the English Hotel in a minute. So they have a lease. Now, the English Hotel has the Pepper Club. That's not a lease. They own that place. So if this place is closing, it's just because the lease is expired and Flamingo has either upped the rent a tremendous amount, which I suspect to be the case, or they just don't want them in the hotel and they just may not be renewing it because of all the Generation Xers and Millennials coming in that are like, what's a Jimmy Buffett? Where's Margaritaville? I Wikipedia'd it. It doesn't look like a country. They don't know. So that's why they're closing up. It might open somewhere else. I don't know. It could be a possibility that it opens somewhere else. Let's get to some of your comments here real fast. Let's see here. So Steven, you really found a niche with these Sunday streams. Yes, thank you so much. And what else do we got? Hey buddy, Victor's here. Dealers used to wear the Hawaiian shirts and shorts, only spot in Vegas where you could wear shorts. There you go. What's the best cab company to deal with in Vegas in your opinion? Oh man, I don't know. They're all the same. They're like owned by one or two companies. I think all the cab companies are basically owned by one company. I'm not sure. So I would say Uber and Lyft are good cab companies. But listen, I should support the taxis. My father drove taxi. I don't know. Let's get through the last news item.
Oh, I got it.
Okay, so we got one more news item here. This one is really weird. This one is strange, okay? So this says Rio's new hotel owner wants a sky bridge to connect Las Vegas Boulevard with the Rio. They're talking 1.5 miles. And it's if they were smart, they would build a sky bridge that was enclosed and they would build one that would go all the way to Las Vegas Boulevard. Now, what they mean is right now, currently, you have to walk 10 minutes and you have to walk along Flamingo Road across the Interstate 15. And that walk is not nice. There's a zigzagging bridge that kind of has to cut and jackknife, and then you walk all the way across. Number one, it's super hot in the summertime. Number two, it's super windy and cold in the wintertime. Number three, there's always homeless people that are hanging out there because they can get that big concrete wall that forms a barrier over the interstate pass, and they can have shelter from the wind that's bleeding through, and a little bit of shade because there's a big metal overhang. So they want to build a sky bridge that goes all the way across to Caesar's Palace. Now, it's going to be like 1.5 miles. You might say that's crazy, but it's not really crazy because they've done this in New York. There was a big project in New York State, in New York City, that connected one part with like downtown Manhattan. Well, the whole entire island is a downtown. So they want to do that to Caesar's Palace. Now, if they do that to Caesar's Palace, they would be very, very smart to spend a ton of money a ton. They're already $860 million into the Rio renovation, but they should spend as much money as possible to make this air-conditioned, climate-controlled, and indoors, and put a security guard on either side to check IDs of people coming across. That is the way to do it. And if they did that, I guarantee you, hell, I'll go even one step further. Put moving sidewalks in there. Like, put like four lanes in one direction of moving sidewalks going west and four lanes in moving direction of one going east. Could you imagine how that will completely change the way that people access the Rio? You would have people just be like, did you hear there's a moving sidewalk that gets us from here to there in like 5 minutes if you walk on it, or 10 minutes if you don't? And it would just be like, pew! That would boost up the Rio. So Rio, if you're listening, which of course you're not, because it's Sunday morning and you don't care what YouTubers say, I imagine, you definitely need to do something like that. I think what they're really just planning, Mama Stroso, we'll get to you in a minute, Mama. Thank you so much. Thank you for the super chat. I think what they're really just planning is an open air pedestrian bridge that goes across. Hey, whatever. You know, wait, it connects to Caesar's Palace. You think people are gonna like be like, oh, the Rio. And then they get out there and they're like, oh, the Rio is a mile and a half away. I don't think that's gonna work as much as what I just said. So those are our news updates here for Sunday, the 24th this week. Sundays with Steven. We're gonna go and explore now. Mama, life has just begun. Hey Steve, is the bed bug issue under control? I mean, whenever bed bugs have to make their gross little heads known in Vegas, it's always a news story. But here's the deal. There's always going to be bed bugs somewhere. The reason why is it's almost impossible for the hotels to control. As I said on the other day on a live stream, the minute you get on an airplane, there could be a bed bug in your bag. Like, see this bag here? There could be a bed bug in the seam of this, and then you bring it to the room and then boom. You didn't even know you brought it in. And then it nested, and then the next person sees it. The hotels are very vigilant. That's not a word. They're vigilant in trying to control the bed bugs, but they can't always control them because they can't always see them. And then when they do see them, they try very hard to shut them down. But yeah, it can be an issue, but it's not that it was ever, I don't believe, out of control. So let's go do our walk. We're at the English Hotel. Be sure to go down to the English Hotel if you're in Vegas. Hey, Anthony, thanks for the text. Oh my gosh. Oh, Anthony, is it okay if I say what happened and you get a bunch of people that comment on it, say yes or no in the chats? I love you, Anthony. Thank you so much. But anyways, come down to the English Hotel. It's a great little place. Of course, our friend Steve Dennis, he manages this, and he's got a channel called Cash or Crash Las Vegas. It's one of the only places where they have nice flowers year-round that are outside. Yeah. So guys, I want you guys to do me a favor. If you guys are a person of faith, maybe you're Jewish, you're Muslim, you're Christian, you're, I don't know what else, you're a naturist, show some love. Anthony Clarkson lost his mother this week, and he's my good friend. He's been watching the channel for a long time. He's been really amazing to me and my wife. I was doing some artwork for him that he wanted to pay for. He's gonna get it for free now because it was of him and his mother. But please send him some love. Give him some prayers to get through his hard time, because it's tough. I can't imagine that. That's a person who's been with you your whole entire life. So Anthony, I'm praying for you, buddy, and to your family and everything like that. So give some love to Anthony today in your hearts, please. He needs it, and that love travels really, really far. We lost a friend last fall, and I know it hurts. So, oh, how would Mike Myers say it back in the Saturday Night Live days? He says, I'm getting a little beclimped. Okay, so we're down here at the English Hotel. Does it have safe parking? It does, Aunt Bear. It has free parking. Another thing about them is that their security guard opened up an extra parking spot that they own down here just for me, because I asked if I can park on this street, and he said you're best not to. So this is Snowball in Vegas. So this is a cool little thing here. Sorry to get emotional, guys. I don't handle that stuff as good as I used to. I turned myself to God, and now I get emotions. Ain't that a witch? A W-I-T-C-H. Which would? Let's walk down this way. We're gonna go down and see this really old neighborhood. This is downtown Las Vegas, some of the oldest parts in town. Chris asks if someone can join me in my journeys. I mean, Chris, you can always come up and meet me. That's cool. You know, people stop me all the time and I actually am a proponent of that. I'm like, hey, come and stop me. Come and say hi to me. As for a whole walk, I don't know. I believe Wall Street Warlord at one point, he suggested that I do guided tours in Vegas for a fee. There's a guy in London that does it, but his channel is massive. And I thought maybe guided tours would be cool on a live stream. I don't know. But anywho, we're gonna walk down here where we got downtown Las Vegas, which is just down here. We're exploring some of the older parts of town, giving you an overall place, best record store in Vegas. There's a vinyl shop down on East Fremont Street. We looked at it last week or a week before that. I can't remember. We're in the Arts District right now. There's a place called Wax Trax Records, and for the life of me, I can't remember what street is on. I think Wax Trax, if somebody wants to Google it, W-A-X-T-R-A-X. Wax Trax Records is somewhere. This guy's screaming at the bus. That's right, buddy. You tell that bus who's boss. Jeez Louise. Wax Trax is, I think it's like off of Decatur or Arville or something like that. Chill in Vegas says this is not a bed. You're right. This is glamorous and beautiful. Actually, we're going to go down to one of the oldest parts of Vegas. What did I title this video? I don't think I said that this was the bad part of Vegas. I'm reading the title to you. Vegas Live, Exploring the Oldest and Strangest Part of Vegas, Sundays with Steven. So, for what it's worth, anyway, I don't think that I ever said it was the bad part of town. I just said it's an old part of town. Oh my gosh, there's a garage sale. Oh boy. My wife and I, we're idiots for garage sales. There's a garage sale happening. I have no cash on me. Last reason I had cash is that I bought bubble wrap on Facebook Marketplace with a couple of super amazing folks that moved here from Connecticut. They're really nice, so shouts go out to them. But I don't carry cash. What have we got? It's a vintage sale. Look at this. This is legendaries. Whoa, dude. This is like real life, dude. Oh, man. You can bring this to the Caesar's Palace and get Usher to autograph it. Hey, how you doing? This is cool stuff. I love it. $5 for coats, hoodies, and jackets. Very neat. Y'all do this every weekend or what?
Yeah.
That's cool. Right by the English Hotel. People should come out if they're down here. Look, you can get your Louisville Slugger so you can beat up some drug dealers and rob them. The problem with that is you got to kill them or else they'll come back at you. I knew a guy that actually... I used to work in timeshare on the Strip.
Right.
And there was this guy and he would buy like a Ford Crown Victoria when he came into town. Because, you know, you go to the police auction and he'd buy one. And he would come into town, he'd be totally fine. And then he would, after a couple of weekends, he would show up and one weekend there was bullet holes in the back of the car and the windows were all smashed out. And it's like, bro, what happened to your car? This guy was wired. He's like, Stevie, called me, I'm like, Steven. He's like, if you're gonna, he said, I swear to you, if you're gonna rob drug dealers, you better kill them because they won't stop till they'll kill you. And I'm like, okay, so I use that.
You probably should leave the bullet holes in it.
Yeah,
and try and sell it.
Try to sell it, right?
And have some cash.
Tell it was Al Capone's Crown Victoria.
The rare Crown Victoria with the bullet hole.
There you go. Cool, cool. All right, you have a great day, sir.
All right.
Yep. Come out and see this guy if you're here. He does this. He does this every weekend. How come you're not in church this morning? Well, I mean, I'm a Christian. There's Christians that go to church every single weekend. There's ones that do church online every weekend. My church, I love it. I love the message. I'm not into the rock concert. That's just not me. It's Palm Sunday. My wife had to explain what that means because Christians as opposed to Catholics, I don't know many Christians that are like, oh, it's Palm Sunday. I know Easter is a big deal and Good Friday is a huge deal. But yeah, so, I mean, I'm here with you guys. I make a decision about whether or not I do these streams and support the family on Sundays, grow the channel, do online church at night, that kind of stuff, you know? What's up, Nancy Smith? Let's see here. Hi from Tom and Cheryl in the UK. We're going to Vegas for the first time in July. I want to check out Graffiti Alley. That's a good place. It's not far from here. Whew, how come you're not in church? Okay, we already explained that from Ed. Guy doesn't care, he just wants to sell you something. That's true, but I wanted to tell you a story, so I managed to do that. Let's see here, heading to 1,000 viewers, we'll see. This one here doesn't say, you know, I beat up homeless people in Vegas. If it said that, and which I wouldn't do that, then I'd have 1,000 followers. There's a lot of weird vibe down here. So this is the Arts District. Well, we're gonna walk down this way, but we're gonna go through the back way down Bonneville and then loop around. So if you wanna buy a foreclosure house in Vegas, this is where you do that. At least it was at one point, the Nevada Legal News. And this is a newspaper that shows foreclosure homes, but I came out here many years ago. That's why I say I don't know if you can still do it, but they would set up a big white canopy tent here in the parking lot. You can see the auction was so long, people were sleeping. And they would have a couple of people bidding on these houses, these foreclosure homes. But unfortunately, it was hard to buy them. You need to be hyper-connected. And then nowadays, of course, the big companies like Berkshire Hathaway and the big banks, they have automatic systems to purchase stuff. Look at this. Wow. Look at the freaking... This is cool. Look at how many of these cactuses or succulents they have. That is some strange stuff, because these, you don't really see these anywhere. These weird looking succulents. This person just decided that I'm just gonna plant, these are not indigenous to Nevada. And I've never seen a nopalis that looks like that. And if you don't know, come on now. This is how they grow. This is not gonna hurt you if you touch it. These ones obviously will barb you. So nopalis or prickly pear generally don't look like that. A lot of empty buildings. Bella, what are the squatter laws in Vegas? So that's a big thing right now. There's a YouTube or TikTok or something. Some person's stuff. There's a YouTube or TikTok, there could be a person in that tree in the bushes. There's a YouTuber, TikToker, I don't know. He's up in New York State and he's teaching people who are here without, look, I don't know. I'm gonna step in it now, aren't I? Yep, here he goes. He's getting political. Oh, I'm gonna type so much anger. I'm gonna rage quit him. Don't rage quit me. I'm just gonna say that he's teaching people that don't have proper documentation that they can like literally just break into a house and just stay there. And apparently there's a really old law in America that says you can do all that. That's all I'm gonna say. So what are the squatter laws here? We're pretty hardcore on private property rights in Nevada. For example, like if you miss your rent, let's say your agreement in your lease says that you have until the 4th to pay your rent. The 1st is the due date and you miss it. On the 5th, they send down somebody, serve you notice. Wow. Ooh. I bet you this place is much better than any of the casino properties. Look how old these places are. I mean, first tell that it's an old place. It has real grass. They hate real grass in the valley. This is a big water user. Second tell, it's made out of red bricks. Red bricks. Like, gosh. This place here probably only seats 30 people. I want to take my wife here. Maybe I should reach out to Chicago Joe's and ask them if they want a YouTube review. Cause like they never get any love. Why would they, right? So we gotta walk down this way. So that might be fun. Mike Lee, I would pitch your gas for a dam tour. pitch in gas. I don't know if I can, I don't know if I'm allowed to Hoover Dam tour people. And also, do phones work in the Hoover Dam? Like that's a question. I think it's a valid one. Because you're in the dam, like unless they put up some cell phone repeaters. Safe to say the dam is like a Faraday cage. So that's fun, Chicago Joe's. Is that what it's called? I have a terrible memory. Hold on. Set an alarm labeled Chicago Joe's for today at 5 p.m. What? Set an alarm labeled Chicago Joe's today at 5 p.m. Okay, good. So I'll remember that. Steven, why didn't you tell the security guy to eat a dog? Well, first of all, you shouldn't eat dogs. Second of all, he had every legal right to ask me. That's another thing people don't understand. You have every legal right. If you're on private property, they can ask you and be like, hey, give me your ID or leave. Or they can demand your ID. And if you don't, they can detain you, I'm pretty sure. Look at this old truck. That is cool. Some of the very limited bike paths out here in Vegas. But look at this old thing. What is this, a Ford? Look at those white walls, dude. Oh, those. Oh, no. Look at that. The white wall is like coming apart. Wow. This is kryptonite because it's green. Okay, I get it. I get stuff. This is a professional job. You ever seen those guys that just take a can of spray paint and just spray their truck? This is not that. So it is a Ford. Wow, I don't know cars that well, but it is a Ford. No, they cannot ask you for ID. Okay, well, I'm going to have to look into the legalities of that because the Nevada revised statutes are pretty, as far as I know, they're pretty cut and dry when you're on private property. So you're in private property when you walk into those doors of a casino, you know. You're in their house. I want you to consider if you guys had somebody come over to your house and they're having dinner with you. They say, I'm going to go to the bathroom. You say, okay, it's just down the hall.
Wait.
Second door on the left. The first door on the left is your master bedroom. And they don't come back for a little bit. And you go and check it out, and it's like, what the heck? What are these guys doing? These guys in your bedroom, he's going through your stuff. He's got your wife's underwear on his head. You're like, bro, what are you doing? Who do you think you are, the FBI? Some of you mad now. Because I said that. You can't just raid my house unwarranted. Anyway, you can ask them to leave. And if they don't leave, you can call the cops on them. I mean, I guess maybe you can't ask them for ID, but, you know, they wanted my ID, Fountain Blue, so they could kick me out and officially kick me out and burn my name into their computers. And then they would read me this little message that would say, if you ever come back, you're going to jail. Would you say it's safe to explore downtown with my girlfriend in the morning at about 8 a.m.? Yes. I think so. Yeah, for sure, Tom Lee. Tommy Lee Jones is watching my channel. And Fatal says, in the old days, they backroomed you. Yep, they can backroom you. By the way, they can still backroom you. Backrooming in Vegas is where they take you into the back, lock you into a room, interrogate you. Now, back in the day, backrooming used to encompass beating you up. They don't beat you up anymore. So this building here is the Mexican consulate. Consulado de México. Estados Unidos Mexicanos Consulado. Aquí es la entrada. En el otro lado es la salida. I just used all my Spanish on you. I hope you're proud of me. So we're going down, man. You can see downtown this way. Why did you kick me out? I don't know. They just didn't like me being there filming. So here we have law firms. Look, how convenient. There's an immigration attorney right next to the consul, Mexican consul. There's a homeless guy sleeping on this law firm. Wow, lots of, see, this is what I mean. Excuse me, pardon me. I told you at the beginning, I said, we're gonna check out a lot of buildings that look like their homes. Oh, this is a nice little home. Like when you say homes have good bones, this house is probably 70 years old. But it sure doesn't look like it. So I never said this was the bad part. I said, this is a very interesting and strange little area of Vegas. So let's keep walking. We're gonna get over to the Huntridge, show you some of that stuff. Mike Lee said I was filming the very attractive lady. There was a girl that looked like she was at the pool, even though the pool was closed, wearing very short, tight clothing. And we saw her in the convention area where there isn't supposed to be people. And maybe that's what it was. But he could have explained that to me and asked me to leave. Instead, he wanted to 86 me. How's it going?
Good.
So, Sundays with Steven. Thank you guys for viewing. Circa is a 21 and over property. That's true. That's it. Feel cold today this morning. It's not that bad. It's 55 degrees right now, 9:13 in the morning. So all these things used to be houses and they've repurposed all of this as a commercial area. So instead of tearing things down for whatever reason, they just decided to make this all real estate and law firms. Now, what I'm saying to you is, like, these guys here, they took the bait. This is not real grass. See, that's not real grass. So that there's actually a giant weed barrier underneath this, and this is just turf. But they'll give you a big old tax incentive to get rid of all your grass in Vegas. What's up, Classic TV Fun? I don't think he could have been intercepted like that unless they're watching the stream. No, that was maybe. So if you guys don't know the context of what we're talking about, Friday night, I went into the Fountain Blue just to see if it was getting any busier. It wasn't. And we went upstairs and then we went upstairs and then we went upstairs again until we got to about the fifth level. We were checking out the convention area and we went downstairs, downstairs, downstairs. And then there was a guard on the main level. Now, they don't have to be watching the YouTube channel to know where I'm going, because once you're up on the fifth level, there's only one way down, and it's through that exact escalator. So all they had to do was see me on the camera, track me a little bit, and then go, there he is, go get him. So that's okay though. Rent a dress and tux. So we got a lot of weddings out here in Nevada. Look at these old buildings, man. You can see this one. This building here most likely had a stove inside for wood burning in the winter time. You can see the chimney and everything. You don't see chimneys in Vegas much often. Maybe this is a dumb question, but does conventional real grass hard to maintain? With enough, Time Walker, you're new and you're in here all the time. Thank you for being here, by the way. No. Yes, no, not really. So this grass here is real grass, obviously. You give it enough water, it's not hard to grow. But see, I thought that was a house, it's actually a law office. I mean, if you give it enough water, it'll grow, but it's expensive and your watering days are very metered. Every single building in this entire area of the state is on smart water meters. So if you have even so much as a water leak, the water company will call you and tell you to address it right away, because they can tell how much water you should be using. Can you ride a horse on the strip legally? I believe the answer is yes. I think we do have laws that protect that. So Chris is here from South Florida. Guys, subscribe if you haven't. I'm gonna tell you 1,000 times. If you guys wanna reach out, you guys can email me. My email's here. If you guys wanna send us a Sunday stream donation, you guys can do that at notleavinglasvegas.com/donate. That would be cool too. And those are the two ways. I'll get the donation right away if you use PayPal or Cash App. If it's PayPal, I'll see it. Or you can email me. And I've had a few people text me as well. 702-546-8107, 702-546-8107. It's Google Voice. If you call it, it will not ring. But if you text it, I will see it. And I will text you back. What is this? So let's get out to the main area. Yeah, so out of all the states in what's called the Colorado, whoa, these are nice. Look at all that. These are not hard to maintain either. If you plant them and you give them full sun and you just let them grow, these will grow forever and they'll bloom in the spring and in the wintertime or the fall. Pretty cool, right? Are these, by the way, these also are great places to see bees because there's tons of bees. Can I see one? There you are. Hello, Mr. Bee. Mr. Bee, come out. You don't want to piss off the bees. They have like some kind of weird telepathy. And they will come at you hard. Okay. So this is the money. Money over everything. Well, isn't that a good message? That's Mo. What's your name stand for? Money over everything. Let's go down to the old theater. Hi, Chicken Scratcher. We are, Steven, is possible that correct move was to talk to the working girl. I'm married, I wouldn't talk to the working girl. I'm actually wearing my wedding ring today. Usually I take it off when I do my night streams. So where are we exploring? So we're on the corner of Charleston and 10th. Charleston and Main is where the English Hotel, our gracious, I call them a video sponsor, but they don't pay money, but that's fine. But they're very nice to us, so you should check them out. So this is Charleston and 10th. This is where things get weird. Wow, this place is crowded. These are closed. Let's go. We can do our zoom out camera on this. If you guys are on Patreon, we posted up, and also channel members, if you're a channel member, we posted up a 21-minute long video, 4K, beautiful, the best. If you've never been to Resorts World, that video is the best look at it you'll ever see on YouTube, because we posted it up in 4K. It's gorgeous, and that's on memberships and Patreon. Thank you so much. Big money. A private business that invites the public into its space is a real gray area about what they can ask for. It was best that you just left Clark County Jail on a Friday. Oh yeah. No one wants to go to the Clark County Detention Center. The truth is, the cops probably wouldn't have booked me anyways, but I would have had a court date. So look across the street. This is where it gets real, real weird in Vegas. Liquor stores, loan offices, hair studios, smoke shops. What do we got? So loan officers, liquor, nail supplies. Hey, look, there's the Stratosphere. Yep. Bridal quinceañeras, mariscos. Yeah, so this is, and then down that way is downtown, of course. And then the 7-Eleven is playing classical music. Ever heard this before? So let's go over towards the 7-Eleven. I want you guys to hear this. Oh, yep, they are doing classical music. Listen to this, I'm gonna do copyright strike now. Is that it? Oh no, he's singing the silent part now. So, I asked one of these folks once, the manager at a 7-Eleven, I said, why do you guys play classical music? Is it because the drug addicts don't like classical music? He said, no. It's not that they don't like the classical music. It's that when they're high, the classical music like vibrates their brain in a way that they go nuts. They freak out, so they stay away from it. So it's not that they don't like it, it's that they can't tolerate it. Look at this place. The world famous Precious Slut 4 Tattoo Company. There's several of these in town. Whew, geez, what a name. Have a nice day. Some of these places are just so closed. This is your suede and leather headquarters. Look, these are remnants of old classic Vegas from back in the day, aren't it? Isn't it? It also disrupts the sleep of folks sleeping there. Good point, Watanabe. So this is the Huntridge. So this place is actually quite famous. This is quite a famous area. We're gonna go across the street right now. The Huntridge is some of the oldest commercial retail in Vegas that wasn't downtown. Rocky's here in Portage, Indiana. Cool, thanks guys. We're gonna be looking at a theater right across the street here, which for a long time was in disrepair, its roof collapsed, but it's maybe in the up and up. So they've tried really hard to revamp this one particular spot just right here. So the Huntridge, you can tell by the old school cool on this sign. So what do we got? We got Garrison Barber, Yukon Pizza, Wingstop. Oh yeah, Wingstop screams classic vintage Vegas. Capriotti's, which is, I've heard, the tennis family. They're based out of Delaware. Been in here for some time. And then we have, of course, Savers, which is a for-profit. So you guys are aware, like, if that matters to you, this is a for-profit, meaning that when you buy here, it's not like you're funding a 501c3, but they do have a really great, oh, I got $3 from Kathy Niece. That's John Niece. John used our super secret ninja link, notleavinglasvegas.com/donate. Thank you, John. Appreciate it. You're the man. You guys can do so too. So Safe Nest is a outreach for women who are battered, women and families. So if you have a bad situation, you can go to Safe Nest. They'll give you a place to live. They give you clothes. They give you whatever hygiene products and toiletries you need, and you can donate there. So that's a good charity. That doesn't go to the folks over here at Savers, but Savers is a good store, I guess. I don't know. So, but they're not closed on Easter. They're open, so don't want you to think about that. The famous 99-cent only store is now just the 99 store. I'm out. It's annoying when you constantly beg for money. All right, Miss Lowlife, you're right. No others. You're gone off the channel. You're banned. Miss Lowlife says that she's annoyed that I tell people that they can donate. Well, the streams are free. You don't have to. And I have no way of knowing if you ever did. You could do it anonymously. But Miss Lowlife doesn't have to be here anymore. She hates my channel. I'm annoying. This used to be a Mexican grocery store. And now it's nothing. By just unused retail space. Maybe we should open up a Not Leaving Las Vegas museum. So this place has tried really hard to make it a lot nicer than it was, which is totally rad. I like how they try that. Huntage Tavern, just an old neighborhood place. And then we have some brand new retail that was just built over here. This taco shop, Roberto's, this is where the wife and I go after the streams. On Friday nights, we typically hit up Roberto's. These are all over the city. There's nothing, you know, this, not to say there's nothing special about Roberto's. I totally think that they're great, but it's not necessarily a special thing. Although this one has a special sign. She's also wrong. All other YouTubers tell people they can donate. Of course they do. Are you kidding me? I've seen YouTubers literally sit in a restaurant in town eating, saying, guys, can I get some super chats? And then they don't say anything. So everybody's got an opinion, just like our you-know-what holes in the back, and that's good. JB says, this is one of the most famous bars. Cool. It's a wing stop now, I guess. The tavern exists, but it's mostly a wing stop. Vinny and Ethel's Downtown Diner. See, this is the kind of stuff that I think is intriguing. It actually exists. We're not really downtown. And the Garrison Barber, Mrs. Garrison. That's Mrs. Garrison to you. So here you go. The theater that just won't quit. This is the Huntridge. That door right there used to be a place that was selling mattresses. The Huntridge Tavern, where are you? Just walk by it. Yes. We're down on the corner of Maryland Parkway and Charleston. We're gonna kind of arch back into downtown area a little bit. If we were to walk this way, you'd see what I like to call Little Manila in Vegas. How dare you, that's racist. Shut up, my wife's born and raised in the Philippines, and there's a lot of Filipino businesses down this way. Seafood City, Goldilocks, Red Ribbon Bake Shop, LBC, they're all down this way. So I call it Little Manila, but nobody else does. So this theater here is super famous. About a year ago, on April something, I think it was 17th of 2023, there was over 1,000 people in the parking lot with a legit drone filming license just to light this theater up again. Because this theater is one of those theaters that existed since the 1970s or 60s, but it lost its lease on life and fell into disarray as this whole area fell out of fashion because of the strip building up so much and because of downtown. People didn't have a reason to come here. So now this is what the plans are for it. That's what they want to do with it. So just study that a little bit. And then we're gonna move this over here. so you guys can see that. So that's the general idea for this building right here. Bald Eagle will be at Resorts World in 6 days. There are some Chicago Joe's videos, but if you made one, it would be the most popular, probably. I'm not saying that like as I'm a jerk who brags. I'm just saying that because my channel's bigger than most of the smaller ones, so I'll just get more hits automatically. Doesn't make it a better video. I'm not an egomaniac jerk. So yeah, the Huntridge. Getting that 5G treatment. I don't know what that means. Salamat, Jeff says. Walang anuman, Jeff. The stage is not merely the meeting place of all the arts, but is also the return of art to life, said Oscar Wilde. So this is the Huntridge. I don't think they do anything here right now, honestly. A couple of movie posters. Maybe they do some of those. They might show what they might be showing here. Could be possibly Asian movies. Yeah. Huntridge sign relight. Okay, so they had a movie premiere here. Join us as we relight the sign and marquee. And then this was The Dirty Hooks. So that was also on the 7th. They did some concerts here. But since then, that was last year, April 7th, they haven't done anything. So if this place does pick up steam and, you know, we can remove this giant premium ultra weighs a pound padlock, then we will probably have something really special here. And I love the history of this place. I love that none of this stuff really exists. And if it does, it's usually been corporatized. It has like a smash burger or a Five Guys in front of it. And this one looks like it won't be. It opened in 1944, JB says. Well, there you go. So the designer of this, if this looks like what you see in Los Angeles, there's a reason. The actual architect of this building was, I can't remember his name right now. I did a quick study on this place a little bit this morning. It was one of those prolific architects that build stuff all over the West Coast of the United States in that style. So we're gonna kind of look and hook back a little bit. And so we're kind of down to where we're gonna loop around and see if we can find anything interesting down here. So it's old. So how I do math on years is 44, 54, 64, 74, 84, 94, 2004, 2014, 2024. So my friends, this building in Vegas is 80 years old, 80. This building is older than most of your grandparents, maybe. Older than almost all of you, most certainly. Yeah, that's a big one. That's a big one. Wait, 70? No. 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 2000. Oh, 2014. Yeah, 60, no, 2024. Let's do that again. 50, 60, 70, 80, 94, 2004, 2014, 2024. All right, 6, 7, 8. Yep. Cool. Thank you, Aunt Bear. It's 2024. Aunt Bear lost 10 years. I would lose 10 years in life. I really would. So this is a type of grass. Somebody was asking about grass growing in Vegas. This is a type of grass that you'll see on the highways in places like Colorado. This grass is actually invasive. You don't want this. This is like deer grass. This is bad. If you have it in your yard, you have to really keep it up. And some people do grow it because it's so easy to grow. Minimal amounts of water, but it grows like weed. It's not that great. So we walk further down east of Charleston. This gets to be not nice. Let's go down this way. We got homeless people down this way because we're stupid like that. And we got a crosswalk here, but this guy's not gonna stop. I don't care. I have a fast car. It's Tracy Chapman over here. Nobody's gonna stop. There's no button to press. There's no button to press. There's just this really busy east-west thoroughfare. This guy's gonna stop. Thank you. You are the man. You understand what the traffic laws are. That's cool of you. So that's fun. So we have like churches, Spanish churches, and then there's homeless folks hanging out by the Spanish church. We're gonna walk on the other side of the homeless people setting up a camp here. They're right over there in that area there. And then we have the Yanteras, the Yantera. I don't speak Spanish, but the words, what's up, bro? How you doing? Chilling and feeling. I love it. There you go. He said chilling and feeling. I love it. So yeah, this is what's over here. So, but I was having a conversation with Rob and Deb yesterday. And basically, like, they live in Inspirada. And they got homeless camps popping up in Inspirada, which is way far away from everything, man. That's on the city's edge. And so the problem is everywhere across America, not just Vegas. I'm going to have the biggest blister on my foot. Because I put my sock on and it had a hole in it. And I should have thrown it away, but I didn't. Now I'm going to hate my life. So this is a lot of redevelopment. I'm surprised by all this. Yantera is tired. I know. Love you, though. Love you, though. I don't speak a lot of Spanish, but when I do, I usually nail the accent pretty okay. Not good. I'm okay. ¿Dónde está el... ¿Dónde está el Yantera? Oh. En el otro lado. Ah. Okay, the other side. So we're gonna walk down towards and hook around and see what we can see. There's an old historic school we're gonna go past here. Look at these houses. They're very old, but they've been redeveloped. Kind of like row houses. I should barbecue. There's no barbecue today. There's lasagna that's defrosting that Caroline made. But I thought it was gonna be windy today. That was what the actual forecast was calling for, but no dice on that. It was nice and beautiful and gorgeous. There's wandering dogs in this area. Yeah, we're walking back towards this way. So this is the south end of downtown. So Sundays with Steven. Subscribe if you guys haven't, because we're showing you guys some history, some news updates at the beginning of it. And then we do uploads on Thursdays. Live streams of a touristy area on Fridays. And then Sundays with Steven Sunday mornings. It's Palm Sunday, so if you guys are worshiping today, thank you for checking us out before or after that, depending on where you are. If you guys are in the United Kingdom, the UK has an amazing obsession with Vegas. Be sure to subscribe to the channel. I keep telling you about subscriptions over and over. If I get about 50 of them today, we'll have 72,500, which just kind of blows my mind. We had almost 400 or 500 subscribers this week. How about a Chinatown walk? Chinatown might be interesting too. I love me some Chinatown. Easy to park, easy to get to. In that case, we would start the walk over at Treasure Island and walk west. Yeah, so this area, you can see, brand new redeveloped, but look at all the bars. Like, my gosh, bars. Hello, bars, bar. So we got bar, bar, bar. Sounds like I'm on a slot machine. Bars, bars, bars. And I'm not talking about the kind that serve you liquor. Even their front doors have bars on them. So you can tell here. Richard asked what Prism Live is. I wish I could get rid of that and permanently, but I don't think I can. Maybe it's a setting. Prism Live is the app that I'm using for this. It's the reason why we can do this stream in 1080p instead of 720p. It's the reason why I can access my wide angle camera here and show you a bigger view of everything. It's the reason why this is in 60 frames per second. And more bars. Let's walk down this way and see how far the bars go. So weird. Isn't this a weird area of Vegas? Come on, share this if this is at all even remotely interesting to you. This hurts. Oh man. I'm gonna be truthful with you. I'm gonna take my socks off. I'm going to take my shoes off. Look at this, guys. I don't want to gross you out. That's what I'm dealing with. So, for the time being, I'm walking in bare feet because it's warm enough to do so. And I'm sure I'm going to regret this, too. I can't. That's going to eat a giant hole into the back of my foot. Throw me a subscription if you see the pain I'm going through today because I made a bad choice. So, they're building something here. When you see these signs in Vegas... Turn my sock over. Lori, why am I not as smart? So when you see these signs in Vegas like this, I should have bought a pair at the garage sale. This is what they have. They have to have this dust certificate for this land. And if they're actually developed, development on it, what you'll see is you'll see giant trucks that are pumping water out on a regular basis. So I'm gonna actually do what Lori said. That's a very smart, oh, that's a pro tip from Lori. If I could turn my sock around. So let's get the front facing camera. What's up, homies and homettes? This is Steven, not leaving Las Vegas. Oh yeah. Oh man, I got a giant missing part of my foot now. Yeah, I'm missing part of the skin on my ankle. Ouch. But if I turn the sock over, that's a great idea. That's a pro tip from Lori. Yep. Man, I don't like religious or holy socks, but I wear them because I'm not thinking today. How long have I lived in Vegas? I've been in Vegas for 20 years this winter. I officially kind of moved here December of 2004. So it's been 20 years. How long have you guys been coming to Vegas for? Let's just sit for a minute. Can you please address the rumor that you are God? I am not ever gonna say that. One of the worst parts about being a Kanye West fan, and I'm a Christian, is that I don't really listen to his music anymore because he says stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Only God knows if Kanye West was saved in his heart when back in the day he said he threw himself to God. Maybe. But at the same time, now he's saying he is a God. That's blasphemy. So I am not going to ever say that. So Vodka says the first trip was in 92. Is that right? So 92, I was 12. Wow, I first came to Vegas in 95. I was 14. You and I are about the same age. Richard's first trip to Vegas was 1985. Ooh, John's been coming 52 years. I don't know, what's a moleskin? And then Steve Six has been coming since 2000. Total's been here since 2006. Kanye needs help. I think he knows what he's doing, unfortunately. Steven started coming here the year I was born in 81. JB graduated from Western High in 85. Lori's first trip was in 2017. Winterman's first trip was in 1978. And Bill Gilmore was 1972. Some fun stuff, man. Y'all are all experts and professionals at Vegas by now. Y'all need your own YouTube channel called Not Stopping Visiting Vegas. Oh, man, the blister still hurts, but at least there's a sock. This is so old. How old is it? Well, it's so old that you can see these old giant fire hazards. Look at the spaghetti wires back here. Typically, when they build stuff in Vegas now, all the power is underground. Sao Paulo is here. I don't get a lot of watching. What's up, Sao Paulo? Ooh, man, I know y'all going off today in Sao Paulo. I mean, you guys are what? You guys are only 3 hours ahead, maybe four, maybe two. And I know it's Palm Sunday. Does the Sao Paulo does Palm Sunday? Palm Sunday. Palm fronds. It's in the Bible. My wife taught me about that last night. I was like, because I don't go to a Catholic church, so we don't focus on Palm Sunday as much. So there you go. My native tribe bought a parking lot, massacre land, and the old White Sands Hotel. I'm so interested in Vegas. Wow. What's your old tribe? Is it the Paiutes? I know that tribe is out here and they own some land. This is Lewis. Where am I going? I'm lost. I'm going to be totally frank with you. I'm kind of lost. I think 14th will go straight downtown. Do we go another? Okay, I know where we are. I think if we go this way, it goes to the historic west side, so we will eventually end up on Fremont Street. Let's continue our walk. Do you know Russians are agnostic? Well, I mean, there's like 100 million people in Russia. I don't know that they're all agnostic. I know a lot of them are Russian Orthodox. I remember I saw the Killers at the Celebrity Theater in downtown. No, it's Mandarin. Oh, okay, Mandan. Hedasta and Akikara Nation. Oh, okay. You're in North Dakota. Oh man, so much better than South Dakota. I'm just kidding. I love you, South Dakota. Don't get mad at me. Don't cancel me, South Dakota. You're the best. You in North Dakota are just as good. These guys have solar panels. Wow. I love these old areas in Vegas, man. Gotta love it, you know? So some of these houses are real old. There's a lot of bars on the windows though. Oh, dude. Frank, I thought you were Steven. I am Steven. Been going to Vegas since 1969. The best time I ever last came in 2018. Whoa, it's been a while for you. Peter came in 86, stayed 11 months, got one death threat. Had to stop, take out the Bellatro brothers. Got three Ricos on me. If I come to Vegas, I get questions from my feds, my passport. So Peter has been texting me for a while. Look, these guys still have their Christmas decorations. Merry Christmas. They must be Filipino. They leave their decorations up. This yard. See, you got a lot of fixer-uppers around here. Welcome to glamorous and glitzy Las Vegas, Nevada, where the houses are 70 years old. So it's conceivable these houses are 70, 80, 90 years old, right? Because the Huntridge Theater is 80 years old. So these houses are likely just as old. Wow, some strange stuff down here. And look, you can see Fremont Street in the distance over here. That's the D Las Vegas. That's the Circa. So the D is there, the Circa is that one right there above my finger. I actually stayed at La Concha across from the Stardust. Yeah, that's part of the Neon Museum. We were there last weekend. Bars on the windows. My goodness. Satellite internet. Who has that anymore? This area is underserved, so they might not have high-speed internet in this area, but I imagine they must. And you can buy this house right here. I wonder how much this house goes for. Can we get some Zillow experts? Let's see if we can find the address of this place. I can tell you what the house is worth, okay? Zillow experts, are you ready? Oh, this house doesn't have an address. I'm not joking. They are renovating this house. Oh yes, it does. It's three, so we're on 305. So Zillow experts, this house is at 305. 15th Street, 305 15th Street. If my Zillow crew wants to tell me what 305 15th Street is listed for, and we can see what the real estate properties down here are like. Matthew says it's $275,000. Is that right? 305 15th, 275K. Linda says I'm very entertaining. Thank you, Linda. Appreciate it. Whoa, bro, what are we doing out here? We're building a trench. They might be installing a fence, but there's already a fence. Oh man, they just cut that tree in half. Those are 100-year-old tree. Trenches, 316. So, okay, so that's worth $316,000. What kind of square feet is it? It must be less than 1,200 square feet. So we got a lot of this out here. Very small houses out here for $300,000. In Vegas, not as bad as California. That house will cost $800,000 in California. Oh my, how did you even get it home? Whoa, how much? That is quite the big accident. This might have been from an auction car. They bought it there, maybe. They said, I'll fix it someday. And then they got stuck on Someday Island. That's what you say, Someday I'll fix it. Someday I'll start that project. Whoa, hello. Those dogs could fit through those bars. I was told when I moved to Vegas to avoid streets with numbers and letters. Oh, maybe. Ooh, honey, I had a little fender bender with the car. Those dogs, there was three of them. The third one ran out, but the person is in the back doing the weeds and I didn't want to bug them. So that's what that is. Thanks, guys. Now's the time where I'm going to annoy a lot of you and remind you, you can subscribe to this channel. We do Sunday mornings with Steven, we read news, and then we go on a walk in a place where you never thought we'd ever see. And then I'll also tell you that you guys can also subscribe for that. You guys can send a donation to notleavinglasvegas.com/donate. So far, John Neese is the only one that I know of. He did $3. Thank you so much. You don't need a PayPal account. You can just do it one time without one. And you guys can also send me an email, nllvcontact@gmail.com, if you guys want to. people have emailed me lots of nice things, some bad things, and some gift cards, which is pretty cool of them. They didn't have to. Somehow, we looped all the way down to Fremont Street, which is cool. I told y'all this is the barrier for where I would typically go on Fremont Street. Let's see here. Thank you so much, Kokomo. But I've seen you in the chats before. I can't believe you weren't subscribed earlier. Did you ever not the other person on the street strange show North Las Vegas Red Rocks? Did you ever not one other person? Do you ever not one other person on the street strange show North Las Vegas Rocks? I was considering going to North Las Vegas today, but I think we'll do that in another video. So it's kind of a neat area. Oh, you know, this is a good sign. What did I tell you about this area? Got the police down here. They're coming right for me. That's the police. Looking at me, probably speeding up, thinking I'm a weirdo, which isn't entirely dishonest. I kind of am a weirdo. So this is where I told you before, I like to see Area 51. You want to see the Janet planes. If somebody watches my channel, says that they're linked up to the Janet people. I can't get in there. Nobody can get in there. And if you do film it without permission, you're on a special watch list for the rest of your life. So I can't go down here because nighttime, you'd be a stupid idiot. Daytime is different. There's a lot of drug dealers and bad dudes that hang out in some of these places. Now, I'm not saying Seagull Suites welcomes that. They don't. They try very hard to keep those people away. But when it says flexible stay apartment on it, you're generally going to be in for a rough time if you don't watch yourself. Is this area dangerous? Yes. This is the oldest part of Vegas here. The downtown's behind us. That's the second old. Well, downtown's the oldest, but this is the oldest suburb in Vegas down here. I mean, I gotta say, like, it's well kept. It's clean. There's no trash strewn about anywhere. But at nighttime, you don't want to come down here at nighttime, ever. It's a stupid idea to come down here at nighttime. So, I don't even know what half this stuff is, to be truthful with you. Old South Cove apartments and stuff like that. Economy Motel. Wonder how much that costs to stay in. I was watching this, one of you guys used my cell phone number, 702-546-8107, and you texted me a story idea. This is the West China Enterprises. What does that do? Like, seriously, what do they do here? And you had told me, you tipped me off about a YouTuber. He's a travel vlogger from the UK, and he came to Vegas and he was stealing the buffet at the MGM. And then this previous video was how this is the cheapest hotel in Vegas. So I figured he must have been at one of these, but no, he was at the Desert Rose timeshare. And I commented nicely. I'm like, bro, that's not the cheapest hotel in Vegas. Oh, China Enterprises. They sell fire hydrants, apparently. What the heck? And he was like, it was when I booked it. I'm like, dude, no. Like, go to the Gateway Oyo. Go to anything on East Fremont. But he's just clickbaiting people. And I was thinking about making a response video because it's very irresponsible, dishonest, and stupid to be stealing food. But he said he ran out of money. But his previous video was him living it up in New York City. And then the other question arises about him coming over here just to make content. So one of the things they don't want you to do is come to America to work. And he's technically working. So I hope he doesn't get on a watch list from USCIS. He'd never come back into this country. That's probably some of the secret Chinese PlayStations. Look at these car dealerships. We're going to turn around in a bit because this is a trip. This is a weird, man. The Desert Moon Hotel. Does anybody know what this is? Okay, guys and gals. Somebody post this. Oh, thank you, Mommy Donnie. Thank you. She says, watching your lives and videos on my TV, wanted to grab my phone so I could say thank you for the great Vegas content, like being in Vegas, but actually in Corump. NLLV is definitely the best Vegas channel. Thank you. Somebody tell me what this really means. Netflix and chill. Quick, tell me in the chats. Some of you guys, it's a slang word. Say it. I won't ruin it for you. You guys got to say it. So they're outwardly advertising what the Desert Moon Hotel is really about. They're outwardly advertising what it's really about. Tell me what Netflix and chill means. Somebody's younger than me and knows. I know what it means. I had to learn. So great, newly renovated hotel. They have kitchens. Some really want to buy something around this area. You got this, and transform me into a party place for personal use only. Hooking up. Yeah, it means watch Netflix and end up having sex. That's what Netflix and chill means. It really is. Look at this. Cash for cause. Really? You can buy a Nissan? You can buy what? $7,600? Get out of here. Oh, wow. You can afford a Cadillac. $7,600. Pay for it cash. Don't take a car loan in this economy. It's my opinion. My advice to you. Cash for cars. But do they have Netflix? I don't know if they do. Look at this sign. Look how beat up the neon is, all ripped apart. Guy on the bike's like, what's he talking? Netflix and blank? Netflix and beep? Yes. So I don't even know what half this stuff is down here. I've never been down here. This is all new to me. When have I ever driven down East Fremont Street? Never. Like, not this far. I've been here 20 dang years. So you can buy them. Oh my God, Steven, I remember how nice this area was. Maria says this was a nice area back in the day. Well, I'm not saying it's not nice now, but like, what is this building? This is a plasma building? I don't know. There's no markings on anything. The Sleep and F Hotel with flashing signs. And Sleep and F. Fatal says the car in Brazil sells for $20,000. Chill in Vegas says it gets worse as I go. Well, that's what we're here for. That's what, 700 people. Have you subscribed to the channel yet? Let me say hi really briefly. I'll turn around in a second. My name is Steven. I'm not leaving Las Vegas. It's a Vegas YouTube channel. We go where nobody else will take you. Friday night, where everybody takes you. Sunday morning, where nobody will take you. And Thursday uploads that nobody ever gives me. So check it out. Thank you guys for that. Yeah, it gets a little dicey. Oh, this is an elementary school with giant walls like a castle. Yep. Wow. Fremont Manor. You can see the eye of the mountains in the distance. Any drug zombies yet? Not so much. We're going to keep going because some of these places look like they've been revitalized and refreshed. But we don't know for sure. There's a bunch of people eyeing my camera, which probably not good. I didn't expect to come to this kind of area today. I really honestly thought that we would be going mostly to the places with law firms and the Huntridge. And then we ended up here somehow. But ain't that the way it goes? Sometimes the best places are the places you don't expect there to be anything. Got the bus lines here. The Sterling Club. Is this the Sterling Club? No, this has got to be a gentleman's club. Find me in the club, bottle full of bud. I'm into having blank, I'm into making love. So come on, give me a hug if you want to get rubbed. You know, does anybody realize what 50 Cent was singing about 25 years ago? 20 years ago? He's talking about sexual assault, really. But it was okay. But if you're a CEO and you do one wrong thing, where's another security guard saying don't come back? And don't come back. It's like, oh my gosh, that was pretty wild. Oh man, there's a place called the Sterling Club. This is not a gentleman's place. I don't think this is not the Sterling Club, which I think is like a private club for millionaires. This is the Sterling Gardens. What the heck? Dingo's mom, I can eat a dozen eggs, scrambled eggs. What is this place? Steve C. Love your name, buddy. I'm Steven C. too. Thank you so much for the super chat. What am I looking at? What am I looking at? This, I've never seen this place before. Okay, so it's like a motel. It's a motel, a hotel, a weekly. I don't know. I don't know what it is. The Safari Motel? Where am I? I feel like I'm 1,000 miles away from Las Vegas. Like, I feel like there was some kind of time machine that I passed through, some time portal. Or I'm in an alternate dimension and Rick Sanchez is gonna come out with his portal gun and tell me there's a mission for us to do or something. Look at this, they this is very much, it's a very Filipino thing, okay? So what do they do on the front? They put tiles, they just tiled the front. That's how they do it in Asian countries because this building is most likely made out of cinder blocks, like this building here, but and you can't really put much on there. So what they do is they just put tiles from Home Depot that would go on your floor onto the building. Freaking crazy, dude. This is nuts. Okay, so far, if I have to show you some bars, it's not because I'm trying to be a jerk. It's because there's certain people I don't want to aim the camera at, so my head's on a swivel when I see those people, because they look like they're going to be angry at me. I turn the camera the other way. The Sky Ranch Hotel. They have kitchenettes. So here's the thing I should be doing, but I don't want to have my two cameras out, because I'm carrying the Pocket 3 right now. And this would make for some fantastic... I've never seen these flowers here. I love botany. I've never seen this type of flower in Vegas before. Wow. There's some stuff here that doesn't usually grow anywhere else. This is wild. Rick Sanchez, you son of a bitch. Dylan, you son of a bitch. Bitch. You gotta say it like that. You son of a bitch. Bitch. Yeah, I said bitch before anybody. Yeah. Yeah, Arnold in the 1980s, yeah, he's in the Predator. Predator and Commando. He said, come on, you son of a biatch. Now the kids are saying biatches. Now as Arnold says biatch. Whoa. This is such a trip. How far does this go? I must be halfway to Boulder Highway right now. Dude, that's another one we gotta go down. Boulder Highway, it's weird. Hotels that never reopened after COVID down there. They're just giant tombs and testaments to the stupid times we went through. Okay, we're going to turn around. Oh, Share Village. This is one of my clients. This is one of my clients from my Vegas magazine up here. Share Village. Share Village helps vets get back on their heels. Back on their feet. Off from their heels or off from the ground. So Share Village is a really good charity here in town. They're a 501c3. Listen, if any of y'all are veterans and you want to donate to Share Village. Whoa, Anthony Clarkson, my man, in the UK just donated $10 to our super secret PayPal link. It's my notleavinglasvegas.com/donate. You can buy photography there. You can find our Patreon there. Patreon and channel members, if any of you want to be channel members with us, they got a 21 minute long 4K video exploring the Resorts World Friday night. Thank you, Anthony. Wow. If you bought an old hotel, Steve Six, yes. Yes, I would market the heck out of you. You and I would have a partnership. We would have a partnership. I would do the marketing. This lady is coming right for me and she's talking to herself as she jaywalks in the middle of the street. We got to turn around. Oh no, look at this. Desert Hills Motel is here. Is it cold today? No, it's nice actually. Yeah, Share Village is really great. They're one of my clients with My Vegas Magazine. You can go to myvegasmagazine.com/digital-edition and you guys can read the magazine online. It's a full version of it. If you guys have a business in Vegas and you want advertising, you should call over to My Vegas Magazine and hook up with me. I'm the marketing director. I work strictly off commission, but I can get you on the cover of the magazine and get you in front of 750,000 people here in town. So see this sign? It's hard to see because it's very backlit, but it says detention center. So the jail is down here. So now I know I've gone way too far. And I'm gonna have to walk all the way back. We're on Eastern in Charleston. So all the retro stops. So I'm gonna go on the other side now because there's no more retro cool stuff to see. So there's not a reason to keep going. Whew. So many Mexican mom and pop restaurants in Vegas and they're great. I don't get in line for Mexican food unless I'm in Vegas. Cover, well, we can do a centerfold, but it's a family-friendly, Christian-driven publication, so you can't be nude. Come take the bus? I'm not taking the bus. I miss the bus. And that is something I will never, ever, ever do again. So I'm on Fremont. I said at Charleston just now that I'm on Fremont. So let's get across the street and walk back towards downtown. I got quite the journey to go. We're way far east of the tourist area, but we're in an area that is historic. Vegas for many reasons. So let's let this guy press the button. You can see over here there's homeless camps. So if you check out over here in the distance, you can see the homeless camps that are across there. There's people hanging out doing their thing. Lots of homeless camps down here. So it's spread. It's not just what I showed you last week. So that's where we're at right now. Okay, so now we got the press button sign. You love the desert backdrop. Yep, we're in a valley. See the mountains in the background. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed by now. Don't wait, do it. It doesn't cost you anything. Our schedule is our live streams on Friday nights of things that everybody showed you, but I give you my unique perspective on it. And Sunday mornings, Sundays with Steven, where we open up with some news from the previous week. And then we go on a walk in an area that you've never, ever heard of or didn't even know existed and show you some cool stuff that's very interestingly Vegas. And then Thursdays, we do a regular upload. And my unique value proposition, if you will, is that I don't want to walk anywhere near these guys. I think there's a drug deal happening over here. Oh, shit. Sorry to curse. I'm going to be quiet in a minute for a minute. Hold on. Quiet. Huh. Shoot. This isn't a good place to be, guys. Because... yeah, son of a gun. I am not walking on this side of the street. Every 200 meters. Whoa, I got Canadian real fast. Every 200 yards, there's dudes. Oh shit, that's an open drug deal. Why did I show you that? Okay. Shoot. Whoa. Okay. I think I'm okay. Oh, shoot. All right. Whew. Can you open carry in Vegas? Yes. But there is also a certain responsibility that comes with that, where you gotta know that even if you're in the right and a court finds you innocent, if you took a person's life or hurt them, you oftentimes do have to suffer the consequences of a civil case. How you doing, sir? We can cross here. This place is really not pedestrian friendly either, because, oh, there's kittens. Hello, Ming Ming. It's okay. Guys have beautiful cats. Those beautiful cats, man.
They're all street cats from around here. So we
adopted all our cats, gave them a better life too. Very cool. Thank you for taking care of them. Yeah, that's cool. He said they live outside and they feed them and stuff. So this place isn't very happy for, this place isn't happy. Shit, I'm tired. That was intense. This place isn't too friendly for walking. There's no crosswalks. And the crosswalks that do exist are about a mile apart. So that makes this a really crappy area to walk and live in. Because you gotta jaywalk. So imagine the cops here just ticketing people. This is actually newly renovated. Tony, I never said this was the worst part, but yeah, I mean, it's pretty dicey. So we got the Sky Ranch. We're doing some renovations here. This is gorgeous though, the sign. The sign ain't like nothing. So these look like they've been turned into apartments. The Betterment community, Bridge Employment and Training. So I imagine this is a community outreach that helps people get back on their feet too. This actually looks really tranquil in here, I'm gonna say. Looks really nice down here too. It's just when you get half a block back. I'm not joking, those guys were passing money in little baggies to each other. So, you know, you don't wanna film that guy because obvious reasons, you know, he doesn't wanna be on camera. Look at all the food trucks. This is where all the Ibarra's food trucks, if you guys are starting a business. Every place has its nice places and bad places. For a minute, for maybe 2 months, before I met my wife and all that good stuff, I lived with an uncle in Huntington Beach. And you'd walk out, so if you don't know Huntington Beach, I'm gonna explain it for you. So Southern California is essentially one giant city from about, you guys can correct me because a lot of you guys are SoCal natives, but from about Laguna Beach all the way up into northern LA County, it's one giant city. So Laguna Beach, Huntington Beach, Long Beach, it's in that order. South is Laguna, famous for its arts and gorgeous coastal areas. Next up is Huntington Beach, ocean, this is the OC, Orange County. And then up there is Long Beach. You know, Snoop Dogg, blah, blah, blah. So I asked my uncle, because you can see all of these smokestacks in Long Beach. Well, there's a lot of oil in Southern California too. Matter of fact, strangely enough, when you're driving around SoCal, you can actually see smokestacks and oil derricks in people's backyards, like little mini ones. The oil derrick is maybe as tall as the Fremont Manor sign right here, pumping oil, right? And I said, Long Beach, that's that dangerous place from the rap songs. And he said, it's only dangerous if you go to the wrong places. You know, every part of every city has its bad places. Just in Southern California, some of those bad places are really bad places. So there you go. Newport Beach. Oh yeah, you're right. Sorry, Laguna, Newport, Huntington, Long Beach. Thank you. Newport Beach is a beautiful area. Very expensive. Super huge money. My dream is to live in La Jolla, but the houses are like $10 million in La Jolla. This looks like a Masonic temple. It's not, it's just a burned out sign. So somebody said I should have stayed in Canada because look where I ended up going. Well, I mean, yeah, you can stay in Canada. That's true. How much is gas in Canada? How much is your electricity? What do you pay for cell phone service? And how long is it to get to a doctor? These are all questions that above and beyond crime should be answered when you choose a place to live. And that's a big thing in Canada, right? So everywhere has its upsides and everywhere has its downsides. And some people in the chats are saying that my goal is to be homeless in Beverly Hills. Well, there are homeless people in Beverly Hills. We were there a couple of years ago, and just walking or driving around Beverly Hills Boulevard, there's tons of homeless folks. It is what it is. get rolling up. We're going to go back down to Fremont Street. Well, we are on Fremont Street, technically. We're going to go to the touristy area of Fremont Street. This looks like a car dealership. It's no longer a car dealership. Who knows what's going on here? Wow, that was a weird trek. Huh. In September 85, I stayed at the Sunset Marquee. Does anyone remember when it used to be rare to see one or two homeless in a big city? Beverly Hills PD will give you bus money. They do that out here too, actually. So somebody was saying that in Beverly Hills, they'll give you money to leave on the bus and food. They'll do that here as well. So when the police have an encounter with a, I'm gonna say homeless person, I don't know if that's the term, unhoused person, I don't know. When they have that encounter, they oftentimes will offer them free transportation out of Vegas and some packed lunches to get them there. But number one, the homeless person has to want to do that. And number two, the homeless person has to connect the police officer with a family member, like a blood relative, in the destination that they want to go to. And then what happens is some of these homeless folks, A, don't want to leave, or B, the family won't take them back, so then they just stay. This is our Netflix and chill. JK stayed at this motel. Is it nice? Might be nice. It's not a motel though, it's a residence. Oh, interesting. Let's read the sign with that phone listed. So it says, hi, I'm just looking at this cool sign. So they're enrolled in something called a program for non-transient hotels. So I guess they have a special program for the homeless that might want to live in a place like that. It's good to know. Unhoused, okay, that's the term. An old bakery. Imagine what this place looked like back in the day, huh? Diamond Dave's. David Lee Roth has a motorcycle place. Just kidding. So we have an old bake shop. I got gas today for $1.69 from Taco Bell. Ha ha ha. We're walking downtown right now on the old historic East Fremont Street. If you guys haven't done so, subscribe, hit the bell. I'm trying to get another 60 or so subscribers today to bring us to 72,500, our schedule on the channel. Oh, by the way, my name is Steven. I'm not leaving Las Vegas. Here's my unique value proposition. If you watch my channel and you subscribe, you're gonna get deep dives into Vegas, critical analysis, news updates, but I don't sugarcoat things. I suspect 9/10 of the news is complete utter trash. Recently, Travel and Leisure, one of the biggest authority websites for travel on the entire planet, said that Fontainebleau is better than the Venetian and the Palazzo. Yeah, right. No, not at all. How dare you? So that's the kind of stuff that I rip apart. And I don't like fake news from either side. It doesn't matter who's saying it. I don't care. I'm not injecting politics, but in Vegas, we have fake news. It's not political. We have fake news that is them lying to you to get you to come here and think that it's something it's not. It is, here's what it is. Vegas is a beautiful place, wonderful spot to retire to if you have the resources and the means, and a great city to come to, but you need to know what it really is. So subscribe right now to the channel. It doesn't cost you any money. You was about to leave Las Vegas if you kept walking towards those guys. Yeah, it's true. It's about to leave everybody, the whole world behind. So 15th Street. Whew. So we got either Ric Flair or Will Smith. I mean, like, woo! Oh boy. Three level temporary weeklies. Whew. As an American, they all ask me why I live in Dubai and not in the States, so I'm thinking of coming to work in Vegas. Lamont says, that's why I'm here. I like Vegas and I have friends there, but I like to move there and I want to know what it is. All right, so we're going to have to do some moving to Vegas stuff. Look at this. Siéntase bien. I know one word means good. Sexual health. Huh. These are good to have, believe it or not, because they teach people to, you know, do protected stuff. Wait. Don't be stupid. Don't get an STD. They'll follow you around the rest of your life. Because our parents don't teach us that anymore. Heaven knows. So we need some water break here, too. I gotta drink some water. Whew. Now's the time where I regret wearing a sweatshirt. Because it gets nice and warm real fast. That guy's well dressed for going out. He's Fremont. My goodness. Whew, man. Give me a minute to stop talking. My throat is very dry right now. Lamont Wayne says that looked like a G-man. Mr. Freeman, or Mr. Anderson if you're going the Matrix. Nobody knows Mr. Freeman reference. G-Man, that's a Half-Life from 30 years ago, an old video game. Slot machines while you shop, yes. Fremont Market probably doesn't have any fresh meats or produce in it. So there's a thing called a food desert. A food desert. The food deserts are where communities don't have access to fresh food options. So in a food desert, you're gonna see a lot of Dollar Generals, a lot of places that don't have fresh produce, fresh meats. They got a lot of prepackaged meals and fast foods. And so I'd say this right here is 100% a food desert, because it's like not a lot of, you gotta take transportation, take a bus, go out somewhere far away to get your food, or you else you eat just absolute trash. We was down here a few weeks ago. Gotta change these phones. Yogi's gonna go to the big TV. So this is like Protective Force International. These guys are the real deal. They're not just security guards. Like, these guys have K9 units and they carry big weapons to big events. They're linked into Metro. And then we have the dilapidated, sad state of affairs that is some of these old properties in Vegas that have been purchased and then they just sit on them. Funny thing is, more drug deals probably happen inside casinos. I'd say you're probably right on that. Yeah, I wouldn't say you're wrong. So we've been down this street before. My goal is to show you the areas that you're never gonna go see because I think they're just fascinating. This is a lot of Americana. You gotta think about what this looked like 50 years ago. Glitzy and glamour. This is where people would hang out on Saturday night by the pool. Now the pools are all gone. They backfill the pools. So this concrete slab right here, this would have been a pool. This would have been what the pool would have been here. But you're not going to see a pool. This hotel. So before the Riviera era, these were motor hotels. Motor hotels, of course, got big because private car ownership after World War II shot through the roof. You gotta remember, hey, Mike Lee. And I got Nelson Lee. Wow, two Lees, Mike and Lee. Says, I'm sorry, but I'm laughing from you running from the drug deal. Mike, I'm a pansy, bro. Thank you so much. I'm gonna be meeting Mike coming up this Thursday. Actually, Mike offered to like hook me up with an iPad so I can run my business better, which is amazing. He's gonna take me and my wife out to a dinner at the Red Rock. And we got Nelson Lee, who'd use PayPal to throw us 10 bucks to our super secret ninja link. NotLeavingLasVegas.com/donate. You guys can also send me an email. That's not the one I wanted. What are you doing, Campbell? You can also send me an email to nllvcontact@gmail.com, or you can send me a text message to 702-546-8107. If you have a story idea or insider tips and information that I should get on. I was watching Jesse Waters on Fox. There you go. I just made half of you super angry. This jerk watches Fox. I knew there was something wrong with him. Shut up. Shut up. Settle down. You're fine. Don't burst a blood vessel, okay? But he had a thing that said, text Jesse. And I'm like, that's brilliant. I want my audience to let me know stuff. And they can text me anonymously. So that's cool. So send me a text. 702-546-8107. It's Google Voice. You can't call it. It won't ring. But you can text me and I'll see it. 702-546-8107. So I'd love to hear from you. Send me a story idea. Lamont Wayne's laughing because he knows. You all know. Y'all know that it's a crazy world, man. So this one is the Lucky Motel. Now, out of all the hotels we've seen on here, this one is the one that looks like it's only a few million dollars of renovations away from actually opening. This is the one that still has a pool that you could probably fill with water. So this is actually kind of cool. So if you're looking to invest or you want to go into a business partnership, I'll help you promote this place. We'll set up a little studio, the Not Leaving Las Vegas studio. My wife wants to do a photography studio and I want to do something for YouTubers. We don't have the capital for that, but I think it would be good. I could advertise it on my channel if you guys are doing wedding photos or you guys want something. My wife is a genius at staging. She can make any room look amazing. I told her she needs to be a stager. And for, you know, you go into the, I'm not joking you, you go to the Goodwill, you pick up some stuff, you spray paint it, you have a couple of fake walls there, you can make anything look like a scene. It would be amazing. Amazing. All right. So this place sounds like they're alive. Ferguson's, they weren't alive last time we were down here. It was pretty dead. So let's see what we can see here. Waters looks like a warm... Yeah, Waters has got a face made for radio, but so do I. I didn't even shave today. What the hell? If that guy's still watching, you asked who it's a good record shop. There's one right here, 11th Street. So it looks like there's actual stuff here. Look at this. All right, now they're setting up a little... Got Hawaiian shaved ice at the Root. Body care. This is cool that this is open. Last weekend they were late getting this open, I guess. We weren't able to see much on it. So, Mothership Coffee, Peyote, this is a good little restaurant you guys should check out. My wife does paper flowers and paper flower walls, but you know, we really just need some capital to do some marketing for her. And then she's debating going back to the Philippines to set up a business for us that we've been working on for the last few years that I haven't told most of you guys. But I'll make a video for Patreon and channel members soon enough for this week. So Ferguson's is really cool. Let me zoom out on the camera so I can show you this amazing looking front facing camera here, look. So these are the real deal. So whereas Fountain Blue has a car, these guys have had these trucks for years, and these are real trucks. I mean, it's just really rad if you look at it. It's an amazing sculpture out here. It goes all the way down. I mean, it's a truck. These are not fake. This is like somebody actually took big rig 16-wheelers and made something cool out of it. How nice is that? The birds like to sit up there and poop all over the ground. Pretty cool, so you should come down here. So yeah, so Ferguson's downtown. There's actually a vegan taco shop and Mexican place in here that smelled pretty good at First Friday. So check out Ferguson's downtown. Is that still Peyote? Is that still the restaurant or they closed the restaurant part?
It's Peyote.
Peyote, I'm sorry. You know, I say Vegas and people correct me all the time. And I'm like, I'm doing a live stream and you're gonna tell me I said Vegas wrong. I don't know. So you corrected me on Peyote.
Sorry.
Peyote.
Well, there's the Paiute Indians and then yes. The Peyote, the Peyote Cap.
Must be my weird Canadian accent coming through. My apologies. So is that still the restaurant? Or it's just a bar? It is. All right, cool. You said it wrong, jerk. Okay, geez, I'm sorry. See, you can do a photo walk like these two girls are doing down here. Taking lots of photos for their Instagrams, their reels. Anyways, sound. The sound's bad, exit and re-enter. I don't know what to tell you, it happens. Happens sometimes. This is the cool place where the letters come out. Not quite out yet. I just want to know if the restaurant's open, ma'am. Don't make me consult the Googles. I want a human interaction. Sorry, I talk with a weird accent, eh? Does anybody remember the old Simpsons episode where Bart gets put into remedial class and the Canadian kid turns to him and he goes, I moved here from Canada and they think I'm slow, eh? That's kind of what that was. Oh, man. You think it was because I was a man? She didn't want to look at me, that's for sure. But it could be because I had a camera out, too. You got to consider that when you get a camera involved, people be like, yo, what you doing with that camera, dude? Huh? I gotta drink it, El Cortez. I got water in my bag at all times, so that's good. Whew, boy, let's go down to Fremont Street now. I'm going to record Fremont Street in 4K for you guys. So here's what we got. I'll show you what's up. So we got the motel down here. So I'm going to try to rig this, actually. So because it's hard to control two things and also look at your camera and everything like that. The whole view changes. Yeah, man. Dude, we were just running from drug deals. Now we got this going on. So look. So this is the pocket 3 right here. So we flip that up and then it's a pocket. Come on, pocket, you can do it. Oh, now I'm looking at myself. So we're gonna go down with this and we can flip the screen around and then it looks wherever I want it to look. So this will be something for channel members and Patreon this week. If you guys wanna go to patreon.com/notleavinglasvegas. So we'll take that, we'll use that one, and I'm gonna install the, the wide angle adapter right now too on it. And also I'm gonna install the neutral density filter. So give me a sec while we look at downtown and I read your comments here, because you guys are beautiful with your wonderful comments. Thank you guys so much for that. Stopping and see if D Scammy is in the Cortez. What is D Scammy? See, there's stuff about Vegas that I don't know that you guys know. So now you feel smart. Gizmos. That's not just a gizmo. Actually, I can't install. Son of a gun, you know what? I can't install the, I can't install my neutral density filter and the wide angle, unfortunately. It's just wide angle or nothing because the way the filters work. So there, that's on there now. That's good. Let's see what happens when I try to turn it off. Great content over on Patreon. Oh, thank you, Irving. I knew you'd be my ad man for Patreon. You're so supportive, bro. Irving Johnson helped. Some of you guys helped fund this camera so we can make better content. So we get that all set up. Oh, D Lucky Experience. Okay. Stop in and see if D Scammy. Okay. D Lucky Experience. I don't want to say other YouTube channels are scamming you because they might say the same thing about me. And that's not very nice. So what I love about this place, right now, right here, like Fatboy Slim once said, right here, right now, you can see so much history and see how things were. For example, you know, you just look across the street, there's Atomic Liquors, a place that's probably 70 years old, still exists. But then there's a condo that was built 15 years ago, and there's a sign from 1942 or something. So, yes, so Steven says the 4K at Resorts World was intense and brilliant. Steve Six says the Pocket 3, it's an amazing little camera. It most certainly punches above its weight. Speaking of that, I need to set it up so it records. It's in low light mode right now and we don't have low light. So let me go back to my regular there, and then I'm gonna put it into pro mode. And I have color as log, 10 bit, good. That's what I wanted. Good, that'll work. Okay, town is like a living museum. It is, and one of the sad parts about Vegas is that a lot of people miss that history because they only sit in the plastic fantastic, which is fine too. But I think history is an acquired taste. I know when I was a kid, I know that I didn't care about it. I know when I was a kid, we would go to Rochester, New York, across the street from New York, Niagara Falls. So if you don't know, I'm Canadian, eh? And it does, Dutch is right, it does. Are you in the Netherlands, Dutch? Bro, if you're in the Netherlands, you're the man, dog. Son of a gun. That's pretty good. Dutch is in the Netherlands, I think. That's pretty cool. But anyways, yeah, it does look like short circuit, doesn't it? I just did the dumbest thing I think I've ever done. I put my water bottle in without a cap because I was telling a story about my childhood and water spilled all into my bag. It didn't hit the pocket three, thankfully. But it did hit, what did it hit, anything valuable? Got one of my charging banks, so that might be dead now. Damn it. Campbell, get with the program, son. That's okay. That charging bank was very, very old, so who's to say it would have worked properly at all? So when you get older, I think you start to pay attention to history a lot more. And I know that when I was a kid, we would go out, and even in the Canadian side of Niagara Falls, you would see a place called Lundy's Lane. And you know, he'd be like, hey, this is where the War of 1812 happened and Great Britain. Well, Canadians lie to you. I love Canadians. Anybody here Canadian? Not all of you lie. Some of you do. Here's a lie Canadians tell. In the War of 1812, the Canadians burned down the White House. As Dwight Schrute would say, false. Now, there was no Canada per se in 1812. It was a British Commonwealth, and the British Army marched to Washington and burned down the White House. But you know, there was all this history, and I didn't really care. It's like, let's just go to an American McDonald's because their Happy Meals are better. Back then it was all different, but anyway, that's what it is. Richard's, I not all of you lie, but a lot of Canadians have a revisionist version of history where some of the greatest accomplishments in Canadian history happened before there was a Canada, but they'll tell you that it was Canada that did it. But there was a British North American Act. So there was British North America. They fought the United States. Confederation of Canada didn't happen until the 1860s. And then even then, they were heavily under control of the British government until World War One or Two. Ooh, I'm missing my history. One of the world wars Canada didn't immediately sign up when England went to war. And the British Parliament didn't really say anything about it. And that was kind of when Canada became Canada. Wow, Judy is also one of the First Nations of Canada, your Cree. So Judy, are you from Western Canada then? Isn't the Cree in Manitoba, Saskatchewan, Alberta one of those three things, or all of those three things? There you go. I heard a Canadian team once won the Stanley Cup. Yeah, a while back. We're gonna go to Container Park. Back in 1992, right? Wasn't it Les Habitants de Montréal? The Montreal Canadiens, the Habs. Let's go. People watching this stream. I told you I'm different, yo. I told you I'm different. I'm gonna give you all the difference. Talk about everything that's different here, and we're gonna give you history lessons and stuff. Hey, I just saw a video about the foreign language guy learning Cree. That's cool. I know Stampede Wrestling. So let's see, Canada has a revisionist view of history. Pretty sure the USA wants to erase their history too. So Isabella, you might be offended that I said that. Of course the United States wants to erase this history too. Every nation does, but I'm just pointing out what I learned in Canada from a social studies teacher. That turned out to be largely his view of things, and that's what I learned in school. It's nothing against Canada. I got family in Canada. I got the love for the knuckleheads still ingrained deep inside of me. The Cats Min Min. That's Canadian. Canadian. I don't know. Here we go. Container park is cool. I like it in here. It's chill. There should be kids in this park at some point, which is nice. Man, she got an old school Polaroid. Doesn't get much old school than that. Those are fun. So we got the souvenir pennies. Pressed penny container park. These are so fun. 51 cents. 51 cents to get that penny that you don't know what to do with when you go back home. That's cool. Steers magician. I am from Lethbridge. I got family in Lethbridge. I love Lethbridge. What's that street in Lethbridge called? It's not Mayor McCheese. It's like Mayor McSomething. I got my family. I remember that about Lethbridge. Cotton candy. Oh man, gourmet popcorns. So this is a neat little area. They have like a stage back here. You can check free concerts at night. Mostly just jam bands that do a pretty darn good job. Mayor McGrath. I knew it wasn't Mayor McCheese. Penny will end up in a drawer. It always does. I found countless pennies, and then I'm a hoarder. Like, I'm okay. I'm not a hoarder, like TV hoarder. But I'm bad at throwing stuff away. Really bad. Kind of neat in here. I'm glad that I didn't lose all my Canadian viewers just now. But yeah, all I'm saying is that Canadians tell you the War of 1812 was Canada versus the United States when it wasn't. That's all I was saying, okay? Please don't get mad at me and hate me forever. There's a place here called Shades LV. You should check out. They sell sunglasses. It's a husband and wife. They're younger folks. And they've been grinding away for a long time. So if you come down, you want to buy sunglasses, come down to Container Park, go to Shades. They don't pay me to say that. She doesn't even probably watch my YouTube channel, but I would love it if somebody could post a Google review saying Steven from Not Leaving Las Vegas says you're the best. Shades Deluxe. See? I don't think they're even open right now, but this place here is cool. It says we're open, but it's Sunday, so I imagine they're closed, yeah. But you should come down to Shades Deluxe. Buy sunglasses from these guys. They have brands and things that you don't even know exist. And good prices and everything like that. And nice people, man. So go on their YouTube, go on their Google reviews. Say Steven from Not Living Las Vegas endorses you. Because I think that you guys should shop local. And a lot of these places down here are hyper-local. Obviously, Steven just seems like every country likes to retell their story in a positive. Of course they do. You're 100% right, Isabel. Isabel. So we got all these, and we were looking for the old ones. There's not a lot of old locks down here. We actually have close-up lens. Not a lot of old ones. So I think a lot of places do this. You put your lock on there. Unless you're this guy. I don't think they sell that lock inside. The cool thing is, if he ever wanted to come back, he could just go get his lock. Maybe he put the key to the lock in there, and he just does a combination and comes back. Not a lot of old ones on here. There's 2024s, 2022s. We was looking before 2023s. That's kind of neat though. And I guess if your marriage fell apart, what you could do is you could put a padlock on it and then you could always take that off and be like, screw it, you know, and throw it on the ground if you had both your names on that. Thank you so much. What is this, maple syrup? Calvin invented maple syrup. Yes. We'll just go with yes. Calvin invented maple syrup. I think the next thing I might do for the channel is buy a scooter. I had a scooter company gave me two scooters a few years ago. I did a review of one of them. I recommended it. And then the next year they sent me another scooter, and then I had my bicep rupture and I couldn't do the review for them on time. And then when I got to being able to do the review, the scooter had died. And I reached out to them and they wouldn't support it. It was a Chinese scooter. I can't remember the name right now, but I want to buy one from Best Buy maybe with a 40 mile range so I can take some of these areas and I can park in a safe space. Then I can shoot out to there and do my walk stream. But then you're on a scooter, so it becomes difficult, you know, or I can film on the scooter using the Pocket 3. But these are all things in the future that may happen or may not happen. Please share Patricia. Who's Patricia? Is she in the chats right now? Patricia, are you still around? I want to share the funniest Arnold soundboard stuff. Yeah, Patricia, you can email me. Send me an email here, nllvcontact@gmail.com. 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 You can see it on the screen right there. If you share it in these chats, I won't be able to find it later. I love my e-scooter, I'd like to bring it to Vegas, but like you said, when I have my scooter, I have to worry about someone stealing it. It depends on if the battery is removable, that's the thing they could steal. You can always lock them up. But I was always worried about the battery getting stolen. So we're gonna start recording with the Pocket. And my commentary here on the Patreon, like again, I can't stress this, it's gonna be, we're gonna film with this in graffiti, so you guys will get a 4K gorgeous view of it, but what's gonna end up happening is I can't do commentary on it. So I'm gonna put on the microphone, but then the commentary is gonna be the same commentary that you hear on the video, but we'll post that up this week to channel members and to Patreon. So it'll be a 4K 60 version of Graffiti Alley right here. So what I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to put my gimbal down for a minute, and then we're gonna walk on Fremont Street with it. Why did I rupture my bicep? Well, I was figuring I had nothing else to do and I was in perfect health. I was training in the gym, but I thought life was getting too good. So I decided to rupture my bicep just to make it interesting. I thought if I could challenge myself, how would I do it? Well, I have no health insurance. So if I rupture my bicep, it's gonna really screw my life up. No, that's not what happened. No, I was doing some Filipino martial arts with a guy. Now we'll point out a lot of these guys that do these trainings, they're like totally just doing it out of their backyard or at a park. So I was at a park. And I was with a guy that wasn't, he didn't know how to stop. Like he went too hard on me. And I was in a hold and we were using these big, thick, half inch thick training knives that are dull as hell. But he had my arm down and he did a simulation of a cut on my bicep and it just boing, snap. It was no fun. So that's how I ruptured my bicep. So we got the Pocket 3. Go to patreon.com/notleavinglasvegas or join channel memberships. And you guys can watch this video in 4K 60 frames per second. Doing. So we're going to go custom. We're going to lower the sharpness by one and confirm that. And then we're going to go to exposure. And I'm going to keep the ISO range here. Confirm. And that's that. Ding! Now we're filming on the Pocket 3. And we're going to film the graffiti as we talk. Have you had beef jerky from the beef jerky store on 3rd? Not had it. It's very expensive. I don't know if it's even worth the expenses that we have on it, but it's pretty cool that they have a beef jerky store here in town. So let's see. Beautiful, yeah. The graffiti alleyway, you should check it out when you're down in Vegas. It's worth looking at. It is safe to come down here in the evenings. There's no problems. This is facing out on East Fremont, but it's the touristy part of East Fremont where everything is very, very commercialized. We have this cool statue out here. Oh my gosh, Kenneth Ketcher, he donated $25 to our super secret ninja link, notleavinglasvegas.com/donate. Thank you, Kenneth. Look at that statue. Guys, can you thank Kenneth 724 times? And if you can't donate, subscribe. That costs you nothing. This is bizarre. It's like somebody's offering to the gods some kind of food offering. That's weird. So thank you guys so much, Kenneth. You're the man, dog. Appreciate you. If you guys want to reach out, you can email me. The contact info from my email is on the screen. I'd love to hear back from you. Welcome to Sundays with Steven. We're in graffiti, the graffiti alley right now. We started off in a much different area and we walked all the way around. Thank you, Kenneth. If you can't afford to donate, at least subscribe and share this video with somebody. And this is our Sundays with Steven walk. And we do these on Sunday mornings and we show you guys a view of Vegas that you've never seen before. Yeah, this is Graffiti Island. Now they change the graffiti here every so often. You have to get permission to spray in here. And it's one of the only, this is the only sanctioned graffiti place in town. This is it. You can't walk down alleyways like this in other major cities. Probably not. So yeah, if you guys want to get a 4K 60 version wide angle screen on this, then you go ahead and subscribe on Patreon or buy a channel membership. I would prefer Patreon, but some of you guys want to do channel members, and that's cool too. I have to double up my work and I do it every week for you guys, but you get extra content. How did I rupture the bicep? How do you fix a ruptured bicep? Well, if you have health insurance, you go to the doctor and they're able to fix it, generally relatively simple. I didn't have health insurance, so I had to have help from the channel, which I won't get into because that upsets a lot of people. And I spent $11,000 on that surgery, and they put in a tendon from the Achilles of a donor that passed away. And they opened me up and they put screws and an Achilles tendon, and they also put a sterile stainless steel bolt through my arm and through my bone that's in the forearm. And then they sewed me all up together and sent me to physical therapy. And I have health insurance now. Absolutely. Health insurance in America is way too expensive. Way too expensive. Canada, one of the benefits is it doesn't bankrupt you to go to the doctor. So I do have health insurance. We pay $550 a month for health insurance. I don't know a cheaper way because the Obamacare exchanges don't work for us because of our income bracket. So if I go to them, it'd be maybe as much, but I'd have to pay $5,000-$6,000 a year just to tap into the copays. So we're going down here. I am filming the whole thing, by the way, on the Pocket Mobile. So you guys can see that. We're filming the whole view. So this way is Las Vegas Boulevard. So if you walk down there, you'd eventually get to, you know, the big famous casinos. This way is North Las Vegas Boulevard. We went there last week. You guys can check that out on the channel if you want to. And we saw like the Skid Row area, and there's some condos down here and things like this. This is where we get to be the safe tourist corridor, but it's only as safe as you make it. You know, you don't come down here with valuables and stuff like that. That's the dumbest thing you could do. If you flaunt them, you probably have somebody target you. Heart Attack Grill over here. Not open quite yet. Last week, I don't know how much I weighed on the scale. I mean, a liter of water weighs a kilogram, which is 2.2 pounds, and I have about half a liter, so about a pound in there. Let's get on the scale. If you're over 350 pounds, I think it is, you eat for free here. Can you keep your Canadian health insurance? Yeah, but you can't use it in the United States. So if you're way over 350, you eat for free because we like to promote the obesity epidemic. And I weigh today, same as last week, 198. Oh, gross. Gross, gross, gross. What are the flaws or shortcomings of the healthcare system in Canada? Accessibility. Oftentimes, at least I'm from the province of Alberta. We didn't have a primary doctor. You would go to what they had in Calgary called Medi Centers. I don't know if they're still around, but they were like walk-in clinics that you'd have in the United States. So you go to the Medi Center and you'd wait sometimes 2 or 3 hours in the waiting room. They might have changed it with text messages now. Maybe you can get a text when it's your place or you're a 20-minute wait away, but you didn't have that back then. So that becomes like your primary doctor, unless that doctor is not there for some reason and he goes and starts a private practice. Then maybe you go to the private practice. And then the wait times. The average time with a doctor in Canada is also very short. Same as in England. In England, your average time with a doctor is very short. I don't know the exact times. I've read only a few minutes in some cases because the doctors have so many people that they have to see. Hey, what's up? So that's another thing that you have to deal with. And then getting access to specialty services can take a while unless you're terminally ill, in which case it won't take a while. But let's say, for example, they think that it may not be colon cancer. They might give you other medicines, and it might be. So you can't get a radiology for maybe a month or two. And in that time, the potential cancer could spread. So there's been stories about Canadians coming to the United States, getting their radiology. They spend $400 on radiology, go back to Canada and say, I have cancer. And then they fast track you. But if you didn't have that ability to do that, then you might die. So there's that. Soapbox Bob says, my doctor is at a Medi Center, proving that I am not blowing BS into your mouth, into your noses right now. So there you go. I love Elton John. So Grizz Girl's father must have had some connection to Canada. If you're like Native American or in Canada First Nations, you can go back and forth, but the Canadian healthcare system does not take care of Americans or foreigners. And you can't pay cash pay in Canada, that's another thing. So there is no such thing as cash pay, they call it jumping the queue and it's illegal. So those are the ins and outs of Canadian healthcare, unless that's changed tremendously. Ernie from Colorado loves downtown. By the way, if you don't know, I'm filming this in 4K 60 frames per second. What's called D-Log, so I'm gonna change the colors to look amazing. You can get this on Patreon or channel memberships. Can I fast most days, but not a full 16 hours? I've done keto, but my wife really likes to cook for me, and so I just eat her food because she's an excellent chef. So I don't eat keto right now. I try to stay a little lower carb throughout the day. The only buffet in downtown is on Main Street. I didn't even know this. Look at that. Downtown's only buffet. From 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. and then Friday and Saturday they have dinner service from 4 to 9. 781 viewers. We'll see if we get to that 1,000 number. I'm dying, my battery's dying, so I'm gonna have to put that down and put a battery pack in soon. I'm at 50% battery, unfortunately. Oh, let's go. Zoom, zoom around these people like an F1 racer. NASCAR racer. Halloween at Fremont is crazy. John Smith says a lot of us are tired. I think I know the answer to the American healthcare system or part of it. Does anybody care to hear my opinion on that? My opinion on why American healthcare is so messed up? Say yes in the chat if you want to hear that. We've got cigars down here in Fremont. There's a cigar. There was a cigar conference at the Resorts World. So the other night on Friday, the whole resort smelled like cigars. Yeah, welcome to Sundays with Steven. We do these on Sunday mornings and we do live streams of the popular tourist areas on Friday nights. We started this live stream out not on the popular areas. So that's what you're seeing right now. And major problem right now is that my audio seems to be spiking a little bit. Not much I can do about that. Hopefully it doesn't sound like trash. So no. Okay, so nobody wants to hear it. It's okay, we won't say it. I won't go into detail, but I will just say, to me, if healthcare companies were able to work anywhere across the country, then the cost would be. So your car insurance, Geico goes across the country. So why doesn't Blue Cross go across the country? You have Blue Cross of Nevada, Blue Cross of California, Blue Cross of South Dakota. So they're all kind of walled off. But I think if one company comes in and says, enough is enough, we're just gonna allow as many people to buy and we're gonna provide them health insurance across the country, I think that would fix things a bit. So I'm gonna put my phone down for a minute and show you guys Fremont while I try to jack a battery into it. Hopefully it doesn't fall. I'm gonna put it on the ground. I can't put it on a trash can. And I'm also going to put the Pocket 3 down on this tripod. But that's what I think it is. I just think it's access to the system that's limited by big money interests across each state. Auto insurance does not cross state lines like that. They're different policies. That's true, but the company gets to work across the country, right? So I'm not asking to buy a Colorado policy in Montana, but I'm expecting that if Geico wants to do business, Geico freely does business in all 50 states and offers similar policies. But see, there, I don't know what I'm talking about possibly, and I'll be the first to admit it. I'm not trying to be the dunder curing effect where you do a 5-minute study and you act like you're an expert. So now I got my battery charger going, I think. Is it charging? Yes, it is. That's good. So we're charging our battery now. That's good. Folks, don't go anywhere. More Stephen Campbell to come. Yeah. I just need to plug my battery pack in. My battery was up 10%. So there you go. So you know. Yes. Please wait to cross Casino Center. Yes. Wait to cross 4th Street. Wait to cross. But that is good for... this is another... Right, Canadians. You want to see a Canadian guy? Downtown Gordy Brown. He does impressions. Like singing, dancing impressions. So if you guys want to support the Canadian connection in Vegas, he's at the Golden Nugget. So... Oh, that guy's ranting and raving. This guy's got Vegas baby. So he's selling children. Oh, that sounded wrong. I didn't mean that in the nefarious way. I meant he's got... shut up. Man, I blurted that one out. I didn't mean that. That's a bad thing. I'm very sensitive to that. One of our charities we work with at my work, at my magazine, it's called Agape Rescues Children, and they're actually against that trafficking, so I didn't mean it like that. Healthcare should be like VA healthcare. Maybe. Anyways, we got... So I studied up on these circles... Because Mike, who's watching right now, wanted me to see if I could get a circle to do a live stream in, and I thought it was a brilliant idea. So these circles are kind of free use, I believe, up until 3 p.m. every day. And then after 3 p.m., you need the permit. And you enter the lottery for the permit, and then you show up to wherever they tell you you're going to be. You may not be in the best circle, but you're going to be in a circle. And but it's they draw it the day before. And that makes it a big challenge for me to be able to do, because I have to work. So if they tell me I have to be somewhere at 3 p.m. for a circle, I can't do it. I love this part of downtown, though, man. All the history. So dope. Oh, let's review stuff. I didn't see my wife. See, it's because I'm looking at this mostly. I'm looking at that for the Patreon and the channel members. How's it going, wifey? Let's review stuff is my wifey. Tonight's din-din won't help your arteries. Oh, no. Well, that's okay. Tonight's dinner is going to be amazing because the wife makes it. 800 people watching. Oh my gulai. Heading downtown, down Tuesday to Vegas. Won't be there until Wednesday, but where will you be walking on Sunday? Maybe I could bump into you and offer you an in-person super chat, Isabel. Well, that's super nice. I haven't decided that yet. Isabel, what you should do is you should email me right here on the screen, nllvcontact@gmail.com. And let's, you know, if you want to bump into me, so to speak. I was thinking next Sunday, I don't know. I was thinking to go to North Las Vegas. Lasagna, we pretend to be Italian. There you go. Send me an email. nllvcontact@gmail.com. Thank you so much. You could also send me a text message, guys. Text me your story ideas, your tips anonymously if you want. 702-546-8107. Text only. It's a Google Voice number. It will not ring my phone. So 702-546-8107. Send me an idea for a story. Last week's video was about a lady who reached out to me on Facebook for my YouTube page, my Facebook page. So I'll listen to your stuff. I'll answer you back. So here we are coming down to the main street. So Patreon and channel members, you're going to get a 4K 60 version of this as well. The connection looks amazing, super smooth. Thank you, wifey. Can someone put that number in the chat? I'm too slow. The phone number is 702-546-8107. Somebody please put that in the chat. 702-546-8107. Maybe wifey can do that if she can hear the chat. 702-546-8107. How about account room? The count room. I don't think we can film the count rooms. That's probably the wrong thing to do. So we got the Biff's Pleasure Palace from Back to the Future here, of course. Pink Box. Let's go show you the inside of Pink Box. Donuts. It's a sexual innuendo, so you're aware. Oh, there's an ambulance coming and I'm against the light. Yeah, so you guys know. It's a sexual innuendo. Why isn't anybody... Type it in the chat for Isabel, please. 702-546-8107. Gonna open this up. Oh my goodness. So this is Pink Box Donuts. Golden Gate will probably never bring back the the shrimp cocktails because they have them at Saginaw's, which is also owned by Golden Gate. But they offer it as a drunk food at 2 in the morning for $1.99. Don't block the box, 100. Yeah, so then their slogan is, so good you'll lick the box. Do you guys see where this is going with the sexual innuendo? Which is fine. I mean, this is a place for adults, right? You can get the gumballs going on, too. Very nice. Do I think Pickbox is expensive? I do think it's expensive. I used to buy this for the office. My office literally had to ask donuts for them because I was buying so many donuts. So our coffees by themselves are $4.25. But remember, you're paying strip prices, right? So we go to the donut menu next. Cold brew coffees. Good old Red Rider. Lunatic Fringe. I know that you're out there. Don't look now, but I got an app that's supposed to help me be a better singer. Let's zoom in on this a little bit. Can we zoom in? We can. So here's our menu. So we got $4.55 for these, $3.85 for the fancy ones. The show-offs are the big gourmet ones. And then regular donuts are $1.95. That's actually not bad for the strip. But I mean, I think, you know, in terms of pricing, it's a little more expensive than Dunkin'. America runs on Dunkin', right? Right? We're gonna go wide angle on this. And I'm sorry, hey, listen, I apologize for promoting it so much. This wide angle is about to look really grainy. If you want to see 4K 60 gorgeous with no grain on this camera, go to patreon.com/notleavinglasvegas. It's 16 cents a day for the lowest tier. You can cancel it at any time, but you'll get that, or channel memberships will get that too. Do they have bear claws? I don't think so. They have apple fritters. I'm down with some apple fritters. So this is the plaza. Let's walk around the plaza a little bit. This is Hash House of Go-Go. It's been a success story. They just opened a location in Orlando last year. They don't have a Tim Hortons. I wish I could invest in a Tim Hortons. Tim Hortons Franchise Opportunities, Canadian famous donut chain. You need a $1 million net worth or something crazy like that to have these requirements for all their franchisees. But it would do really well in Vegas because nobody's opened one, and there's a lot of visitors that come from Ohio, New York State, New Hampshire, New England. I think they have them there, but it's all over Canada. Tim Hortons is a prolific Canadian brand. If Tim Hortons is one of them. Hey, what's up? Hey. Cool, you want to be on my camera?
No, I'm good.
What's your name?
My name's Dave.
Dave, nice to meet you, Dave. How do you like flat?
It's interesting. I stayed here when I was 20 years old, like 90 years ago.
Okay.
It feels like it hasn't changed, but it's okay. It's pretty good. We did the whole room for the games, so that was nice.
Nice, man. Nice. Okay. Okay, Dave.
Yeah,
nice to meet you. Nice to meet you, brother. Thanks for watching. You too, my man. Let's see here. Watch Plaza is okay, if I'm being honest. Plaza has a whole area. Lost my entire stream here before. So I walk in. Usually it's okay. It got better just now. Good. So yeah, usually these hotels that are smaller, they've wised up. I know John is the CEO of this place. I think I'm going to email him this week, ask if I can be on his podcast. I never really used to do that kind of stuff because I thought nobody liked me. I have problems with self-image. But I'm gonna email him. Maybe I'll be on his podcast. But I know that they embrace the YouTube scene, which I think is pretty fantastic of them. They don't have to. Let's go to the non-smoking area here that is made for social media to show you guys what that looks like. No, it's all fat, no muscle. I gained a lot of weight. I stopped training. I ate like trash. I got depressed. We lost a friend, a family member, essentially. Reasons I won't go into right now until I discuss it with Sweet Caroline about what we want to disclose about that situation. And it sucked, and I'm fat now, and my jeans don't fit. Oh man, that's no bueno. But let's go over to the area that has the non-smoking. It's so nice. It smells so good in here. It's beautiful. Tim Horton, the man, died tragically in a car accident. Was Tim Horton intoxicated? So Tim Horton... but I could be wrong. And so he was driving a prolific brand based on his name. Tim Hortons got famous in Canada. It smells so good in here. You know that? No smoking. It smells like brand new. I love it. So Tim Horton was famous in the 80s for a commercial where they would pour out the coffee after 20 minutes and make a new pot. And we got the reward center here. And I remember seeing it. I can see it in my head. It's a driving snowstorm somewhere in the middle of nowhere, Canada. And the lady pours out a pot of coffee and makes a fresh one. And then a snowplow driver comes in and drinks the coffee, and he's so appreciative. So this is the Brian Christopher endorsed smoke-free slots area. Something you don't know about Brian Christopher, he is 9 feet tall.
Hi, I'm Brian Christopher. My life's hard because I can't drive in cars.
No, that's not true. Is this open? That is a giant misrepresentation of his actual height, to be certain. Nothing beats a good old cup of joe and some donuts in the morning. So Monty, that was the Plaza Hotel. The Plaza Hotel. This guard just watched me come out of that area. Now, time was that a guard like this would tell me to stuff it if I had a camera out here, but they don't seem to do anything anymore, so I gotta give them a major props for being switched on to the way the world is now. It smells really good in there. Richard Gambler. I wanted to be on Brian Christopher's channel back in the day. Never came to pass. But you gotta remember, when you're in Brian Christopher's position, he's got hundreds of thousands of followers. He's made multiple millions of dollars on his YouTube channel. He doesn't need to have me on. Maybe if he liked my content, he'd have me on, but I don't think he can pay attention to everything. It's impossible for us to pay attention to everything. It's just so hard, because how are we gonna do that? All right, so here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna put this to rest right now, and we're gonna put this away, because we're gonna go back to paying full attention to you guys. Zoop. There you go. How'd you do? So let me go put this away in a minute when this street crosses, and I'll give you guys my full undivided attention. Oh, you saw him at Seneca, at the Seneca. I remember back in the day, we used to go over to Niagara Falls, New York, where the Seneca Casino is. And we used to go over there, and it was actually called Niagara Square, I think. And it was a shopping mall, because back in the 80s into the 90s, certain things would come out of the United States before Canada, particularly like video games and stuff. Video games didn't have release dates. Like that all changed with a game called Sonic the Hedgehog 2, Sonic Part 2. Sega, back in the day, that owned the property, said, we're going to launch this on Sonic Tuesday. So they made a date. It was Tuesday. But before that, you would just have to go into a store, like a Toys R Us, and hope that you could find the thing you were looking for. And in Canada, they notoriously got things late. So we would go over to Niagara Square, drive over. We called it colloquially. Colloquially, as they say, oh, drunk gimbal alert. Oh, drunk gimbal, you got to stop the margaritas. Colloquially, they call it going over the river. At least they did. I don't know if they still call it that. And that's what we did. And Niagara Square, and then they built Casino Niagara on Niagara Falls, Canada, and then the other side said, hey, let's build a Native American casino, and then the rest is history. Richard's on the YouTube show. What casino has the old donut bar? I don't know the old donut bar. The donut bar is closed. It wasn't in a casino. It closed up shop some time ago. But it was just off of one of these little side streets that we've been looking at all this morning on the stream. Let's see here. Just being in the same vicinity as Steven will send you shivers and shit. Dixie's my hype gal. I got a hype man with Wall Street Warlord. And I got a hype gal with Dixie. Are you kidding? Thank you, Dixie. That's nice of you. Super nice. You guys are my Flavor Flaves and my Flavor Flavettes. Right? Yes. So yeah, Fremont Street is really cool. Come down here in the mornings because you get the whole place to yourself. And it gives you a whole different perspective as to what you're actually looking like. You know, you're looking at the ceiling above me, the sun is shining through. They do music and stuff down here on the days, and the music's a little bit different as well. But it allows you to see a perspective of everything that you don't usually see. This is called the rule of thirds. You can see two thirds of everything. I remember working down here doing timeshare like these folks here. I hated it. I linked up my lack of success in an industry to hating Fremont Street. That was the wrong way to do it. And the showgirls, man, she's drinking wine. It's 1 o'clock. She's drinking wine on that camera. It is. What time is it for her to be drinking wine? 11:13. Don't judge. You got something you do that you don't like that you do that people would not approve of. So I linked up not liking Fremont Street. And at a point, even last year, these words came out of my mouth. I swear to you not. Don't hold this against me. I abhor the Las Vegas Strip. My biggest regret saying that to my wife, because it's given me everything. And I'm Steven. I'm not leaving Las Vegas. Subscribe to this channel right now. We do Sunday mornings with Steven. It starts off as a news update for what happened over the week. Then we transition into showing you something crazy that you've never seen before. And it's not Fremont Street. We just end up down here today. So, you know, make sure you check out the channel, subscribe. If you guys want to send us a super ninja, super chat that's Google can't take money, YouTube can't take money out of, notleavinglasvegas.com/donate. And I'm going to do one more thing here. I need to do this. Oh man, don't want that. So we're gonna do this. 702-546-8107. So if you guys wanna text me, you guys can send me a text. And this is the number right here. So I'm gonna move this down here a little bit. Can I move this down here? I can't. So if you guys wanna text me, send me a text here. 702-546-8107. And you can't call me, but you can send me a text. If you have a story idea, you have a hot tip, you wanna remain anonymous, you guys wanna do something with me that won't work with me, you have a business you want me to advertise, let me know, okay? All right. See if I missed some chats here. I'm sure I did. Is my wife Filipina? She is. Is there always a band down there? Mostly, but this is just music playing over the speakers. So here we go. Well, we love your show, that's for sure. Make sure you share this somewhere if you have a love for it. Appreciate it. Yeah, that would be great if you guys want to share this somewhere. We enter into almost our third hour here on Sundays with Steven. So we do touristy type stuff on Fridays on a live stream. We'll show you the strip of Fremont Street. We do these weird surreal walks on Sundays to show you stuff you ain't never seen. And then we also do a static upload on Thursdays. And I also have my channel memberships and my Patreon. So if you guys want to support us and get extra content, channel memberships or Patreon are a great way to do it. Patreon benefits more than channel memberships, but both are appreciated. $2 billion to the businesses, maybe. That's a pretty big number, but I've been doing this 5 years, so let's assume that we generated some positivity for some of the places that we've looked at. So we were talking on Friday about how these companies don't do Win a Car anymore. But the D did it, but look, they do it down here. You can get a Shelby truck. Does anybody want to know what is this Shelby F-150 truck worth? I mean, again, this isn't a Raptor. Raptors are expensive. What's a Shelby F-150? Can somebody tell me the MSRP on a Shelby F-150? We're in the Four Queens right now for a minute. We got a place back here. Can't remember the name, it's a restaurant. It's terrible. Magnolias, Margiano's, can't remember, not Margiano's. Mr. Campbell, you have to leave our property on Fremont and don't come back, right? So somebody wanna Google what a Shelby F-150's retail value is? Cause that's a pretty amazing looking truck. I mean, you see the Raptor, but this is a Shelby, you know? Winner is responsible for taxes. 90,000, I think. This is the rub though. Winner is ultimately responsible for taxes. Backup withholding will be collected at time truck is full on. No cash option. Management reserves all rights. So I'm gonna I'm going to go ahead and let you know about this truck. This truck is a cash prize, and you have to pay the IRS for this prize. I had a friend out here that I knew. He sold Grand Canyon tours, and I was talking to him, and he was on Jeopardy. No, Price is Right. Pardon me. He was on the Price is Right. He won the Showcase Showdown. His Showcase Showdown was worth $55,000 on the Price is Right, and he couldn't afford to accept the prize. He couldn't afford to accept the prize because they were going to give him the tax withholding. They said, sign this piece of paper for the IRS because they want to make sure you're going to pay the cash value of this, or you can cash out for way less. So he did a cash out for way less, and that truck has no cash option, which means if you want the truck, you're going to have to pay a lot of taxes on that truck. Up front, sign a piece of paper that says, I owe the IRS this much money, and they file it. So your tax burden gets up there. So just so you're aware of that. And if you don't, then you don't win the truck. They'll draw somebody else's name. So Fatal says that truck's been there since before the virus. Maybe, but they've had several trucks there. Well, you sure it was that one and it wasn't a different one? I'm not saying that's incorrect info, because I mean the D, they're constantly putting their trucks in and out. This guy in the circle, he wants to get donations today. For what, I'm not sure. I don't know that he is actually performing. Interesting. We got the chicken man down here. Sha la 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 la. My mom, friend Joanne, won $100,072 publishing clearinghouse tax-free in Canada. These guys here are a charity, but they can't show you their charity papers. So I want you guys to be careful when you have people in Vegas that are telling you that you want, that they're a charity. If they can't show you their 501c3 and you can't research it on your phone to see if it's a registered government operation, I would be really, really careful about not giving people money on Fremont Street. Okay? Look, somebody called me. I told you not to call me. I have a missed call. I told you, look, somebody, I can't show the phone number, son of a gun. Somebody from a 217 area code called me. I said, I'm not going to answer the calls. My phone doesn't ring. It's set not to ring. I'll get an email that says I missed a call, but guys, no. Heavens no. I've had that Google Voice number for 10 years. I get so much random calls on there, I can't turn it on for you. But I can. You can text. If you want to text, we're good to go. I had a 403 number text me. That's fun. I can't tell you who called. It was somebody in a 217 area code. It might have been the nice person that was texting me last night. They wanted to know where they could donate, and I gave them some options, and I don't think they did, but they know the options now. And I said, even a dollar I appreciate. And they said, man, if you had 1 million people donate a dollar. I said, ain't that the dream? Take a left behind the D. Is this the D? This is on Carson, right? We're walking back towards the English Hotel now. Hey, how you doing? How'd they get your number? Here. You can text me. See? 702-546-8107. 702-546-8107. If you got like a hot tip or a hot lead, you got a story idea, you can text me right there. So that's how I give my number out to people. What's the harm? It's a virtual number. It's not my real phone number. And if somebody wants to text hate stuff towards me, I'll just block them. But I might, I want to connect with y'all. That's the thing. So this is the downtown event center. They do all sorts of shows. The camera's looking all stupid because of the, what's happening here is the electrical frequency going through this doesn't line up with my shutter speed. So it looks weird. Reggae Rise Up. We got invited to that by Chef Rex a year or two ago. That was a fun show, man. Thank you, Chef Rex at Project Barbecue for that. So close to the new donut bar. Well, we got a lot of time to explore down here. The wind is kicking up. That is a bummer. My goodness. Let's walk down this way. We're also close to the Clark County Detention Center. Yeah, you guys can text me if you guys want. Be nice, be a human. This is how this looks down here, by the way. So, it's all artificial grass, but it looks nice and well kept, and that big concerts here sometimes. So that's owned by the D Circa / Golden Gate folks, Derek Stevens group over there. I've been trying to get with Richard Wilk, text him back and forth. He asked me to text on Tuesday. Somebody requested an interview with him. He said, that's really cool. I told him, hey, Richard, I rebooted my channel. Let's get together. He's not against the idea, but he's just incredibly busy. Richard Wilk, I mentioned him because he's like the main marketing guy behind Circa and all these different places, which is the people who own the event center right there. It'll threaten to rain like this all the time in Vegas. It doesn't mean it's going to rain, but you know. Yeah, we've had some sprinkling of showers here and there throughout the valley in the last few weeks. Some big rain, some little rain, some no rain. Boy. 2 hours and 44 minutes of walking. Start off, now I have a giant blister on my foot. Somebody in this chat gave me the great idea to flip my sock around. That was smart. Got to throw away your holy socks that are holes, filled with holes. How do I like living in Vegas, Monty says. I mean, it doesn't snow, hardly rains, a little hot. Statistically on the camera, there's only 17 days in Vegas that are over 100 degrees, but I call BS on that. That's what they say, I guess. Maybe, but it sure seems hot for a lot longer. So we got some interesting stuff. Law library, public defender. So if you need to get a free lawyer, I guess this is where you go. We are right by the Clark County Detention Center, of course. This is called Wedding Row. You can hear the church bells. That's cool. That's neat. This is what they do. They make it look like they're the wedding bureau. This is the wedding bureau, but it's not where you get a wedding license. This is not that building, but they make it look like that. It's like a chamber of commerce, the wedding bureau. Have ever walked from downtown to the strip? Certainly I have, a few times actually. It's a nice little walk. At night it can be a little dicey, because once you leave the touristy areas, it can be a little weird. 771 people watching. Have you guys subscribed to the channel yet? Subscribe to the channel if you guys want a great experience with Vegas and regular video uploads. We're barreling towards 100,000. I know, 72,000. But look, if I had 60 people subscribe on this stream, then we're at 72,500. And just a week ago, we were at 71,900. So we're growing, and I want you guys to be part of that growth. Be part of the growth. This is the Regional Justice Center, and the actual Wedding Bureau area is on the other side of this. So Regional Justice Center, if you have to pay a parking ticket, if you have to do a court thing, this is where you go for that kind of stuff here. So this is where you might go. Let's go zoom out a little bit. Get the scope of this whole building. Pretty big building. Thank you, Louise, for subbing. Appreciate you very much. We're fighting our low battery warning again, but I should be okay. Charged it up a bit. So yeah, this is downtown Las Vegas. So Wall Street Warlord's always the hype guy. We appreciate him doing that. Somebody's like, no caps, but hey, caps are okay. Caps are okay. I think the weddings is on the other side of this ramp right here. So yeah, if you guys are arrested in Vegas and you're processed and you're a tourist, you know, most of the time you're gonna post bail, put up bond, and then you're probably gonna hire an attorney. And then you're never gonna really have to stand before a judge in Vegas. Most of that stuff is done for you. I mean, it's very difficult to get put in prison for a long time in Vegas if you're a tourist. I suppose if you did something really nefarious. Here's the Marriage License Bureau. This is where you'd go. Yeah, it looks, you know what? Legit, it looks like rain now. Dios mio, I just washed the car yesterday. Of course I did. So this is where you get your marriage. You got Elvis up here. The wedding capital of the world. Lost wages. Are September temperatures still high? Yes, can be high. Oh, you got to press a button, I'm sure. It's closed for now. I don't know. Oh, they're open from 8 a.m. to midnight. So the door is just closed. Oh, it's open. I'm stupid. So this is pretty unremarkable. You need a limited edition one. That's what your marriage certificate keepsake looks like. And then these people are all getting married. Going to the chapel and we're gonna get married. You can take a selfie here with the crane in the background, of course. Lots of construction downtown. So, yeah. So you come down to Vegas to get married. What some people will do is they'll actually get a marriage license, and that's the date you get the license issued, and then you have the ceremony later. Some people will get married back home and then come to Vegas to do the ceremony, even though they have a license in another state. They just pay for Elvis to marry them or something like that. So they'll do two marriages, one with their family, and then they come to Vegas and they have their fun one, and then they have their honeymoon in Vegas, which is the name of a movie. Of course it is. So we got bail bonds offices and stuff. We're walking down towards the strip. You can see towards the strip. What's the temperature right now in Vegas? In Vegas is 61 today. Not particularly warm, not particularly cold. The wind died down, so we're good there. So see, they try to trick you. So you might come here and you think that this is your marriage commission. Marriage is starting at $50, but that's just for the ceremony. So you still have to go to that building we just came out of in order to officially get married in Vegas. Lots of people get married here. One of the reasons why this place got popular back in the day was because we had a no-fault divorce and fast marriages. So what ended up happening was in California at the time, like Arnold would say, in California in the 1920s. Back in the day in California, you needed to apply for a license and then wait a week or two. And so celebrities wanted to get married, but they didn't want the media to know about it all the time because it would have been a big fiasco and everybody would show up and hound them. So they would come to Nevada where you could get a marriage license and get married the same day without many people knowing about it. And then divorce used to be a lot different. A divorce decree used to, in a lot of areas, used to have to go through the court system. And so it would take a while for you to get a divorce. And you'd have to argue your case as to why the marriage should be dissolved, absolved, whatever the word is. But Nevada said, no fault divorce. Just come out here. Say you don't want to be with this guy anymore. We'll grant you a divorce. So people started coming out here to get their divorces really fast. And it also helps that, you know, it's a giant tourist town. There's like a big old police action happening over here. There's like, well, you can't see anything now. Wow, there's like several cop cars. What's going on here? Oh wow, let's go see. Guys, we do stupid things. The way I see it though, when there's a lot of cops, you're probably safe. So we're gonna go down towards Bonneville Transit Center. Wow, 2 hours and 52 minutes on a live stream. Gosh. That means that this week I did 5 hours of live streaming. That's good. That's good that I can eat all the chocolate I want today, right? That's not how that works. No. Wrong way. Oh, man. Early October, it's warm. Well, October's weird. October, it might be 70, 75 in the day, but 45 at night. It gets cold at night sometimes in October. So you end up having to bring two different sets of clothes. There are four cop cars down here, and transit security and downtown city of Las Vegas deputies everywhere. What is going on? Dun 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 dun. Let's see, lots of cop cars. We're just off of the main tourist area here at the Bonneville Transit Center. So how many miles or kilometers did I walk? I have no way of knowing. So if I install a pedometer app on my phone, it's just gonna chew through my battery faster. And the Apple Health app is fantastic, but for whatever reason, doesn't tell you how many miles you walk. I'm sure I could figure it out by going into the health app, which I can't do while I'm on a live stream, of course. And then trying to see how many steps it says I've taken today. And then figuring that it's early morning, so I started mostly, you know, early. And then doing some math. But even then, a step is different from everybody. Have they taken a cat bus? Are they safe? So yeah, Citizens Area Transit is what it used to be called. Now it's called the RTC, the Regional Transportation Commission. So they changed the name a while back. Look at this.
How about those snakes?
Sure. Any idea what happened over here?
I believe it was, has to do with stolen vehicles.
Oh, okay.
So they got about 4 or 5 guys.
Oh, they arrested 4 or 5 guys?
Oh, yeah.
They got a ring, it sounds like.
Yeah.
Carjacking ring, man. I don't know what it's worth.
It is what it is.
Steal my catalytic converter theft or car theft? I don't know which is worth.
And I was a victim.
Oh, man, I'm sorry. Did you get your car back? Or parts of it?
Long story, by the way.
Yeah? I'm sorry to hear that.
They just took 2 feet of pipe. They didn't take my catalytic converter.
They just took part of the exhaust?
Yeah.
Why?
I have no idea.
Scrap metal, man.
Yeah.
Did you hear?
The thing is, the catalytic converter was still there.
They said...
It only took me $80 to get fixed.
There was a news report that said one of the reasons so many of the streetlights don't work is because over the last 2 years, $7 million of copper has been stolen from the city. My goodness. Man, what a world we live in.
Yeah, I know.
All right. Well, thanks for keeping us safe.
Right.
Appreciate you.
Good luck on those
next. Yeah, thank you, sir. I don't like the Knicks, and I didn't want to say that. I don't know anything about the Knicks. Somebody sent me the shirt. He's referring to the shirt. Somebody sent me a shirt. One of my great viewers, and I'm wearing it because it's warm and because it's a conversation starter. So carjacking ring. So they arrested 4 or 5 guys in a carjacking theft out here. My goodness. Kind of wild, hey? I'll give you an idea of how this looks, too. So this is our city, our sweet town. This is the roads and the bus routes on the town. You're downtown right now. That's where everything goes. And so you're downtown, you're down here right now. Touristy stuff is up here, and we're down here. And then this is how the city is kind of laid out. It's a big sprawled out city. So somebody had asked me if the bus is safe. That's a really hard to answer. It's not safe if you're not safe. Does the loop pick up at the transit center? The loop, if you're referring to the Vegas loop, it's not built out this way yet, but it's supposed to. The Vegas loop is Elon Musk's underground transit system that is legitimately under construction right now. And it will someday come down here. So yeah, so is the bus dangerous? So I was an idiot and a victim of crime in San Diego because I had an iPod back in the day when the iPod Color came out, and I was listening to it, had it in my hands, and I was sitting by the back door on the bus, and somebody was watching me, and he knew when the bus was gonna stop. He pressed the button, he snatched it out of my hands and ran away. There, the bus isn't safe when you do that. There's been a lot of instances. One lady's in jail for murder or for manslaughter, homicide, because she got into an argument with somebody in front of the Paris, and it was an elderly gentleman, and she pushed him out and he fell out and smashed his head on the concrete and he passed away tragically. So that's not safe. So don't mouth off to people when you're on the bus, right? And then the cool thing about the bus is, though, you can sit on the top level and you can get a neat double-decker bus for $5. You really should do the double-decker bus tour. It's fun, but it costs like $45. So, you know. So, oh man, oh man, oh man. Don't leave anything of value in your car because someone will break the car window and take it. Yep, that is true and sad. We're walking back towards the English Hotel, taking the back ways. A lot of this stuff is gonna be redeveloped. This whole area will probably be another promenade full of tourist stuff. Back door on the bus. I don't know what that means, but I know that Chris Cross missed the bus. And that was something they will never, ever, ever do again. Nobody knows. I say these old 90s references. And, you know, So the bus is as safe as you want to make it, I suppose, because if you do things that will cause you to piss people off that want to take their violence out on you and their anger, or if you have your valuables, you know, like you probably have Bluetooth headphones. So if you have to listen to Bluetooth headphones on the bus, put your phone deep into your pocket. Don't let anybody see it. They're not going to steal what they don't know you have. Hop on the bus, Gus. Get in the back, Jack. Oh, I see it. It's a song. Good idea about turning the socks over. That was Laura's idea. Because now I have a big, bloody, gross spot on my ankle. Because I wasn't paying attention when I put the socks on. Oh, man. This is some of these little places down here. So old, man. These are like 70, 80, 90-year-old buildings. No need to be coy, Roy. Carry a new gun, son. Yeah, nowadays. Lock and load, Dennis Leary said back in the day. So let's go and show you our gracious parking hosts, the English Hotel. Advocate for them. And I should really partner up with the English Hotel. But they already have an official blogger. It's Steve Dennis with Cash or Crash Las Vegas. We wanted to do some... my wife does paper flower walls. You should go to carolinespaperblooms.com for hire. And they were talking about building in some kind of an event center over at the English Hotel and doing weddings. So we were talking about that with them. Have I gone to Count's Cars? No, I've not. There's a lot of stuff I haven't covered on the channel. I'd love to show you guys. The little camera makes it possible. If you guys want to get a 4K 60 frames per second color graded, which means I'm going to tweak the colors so it looks just great, version of Fremont Street, go over to patreon.com/notleavinglasvegas. Channel members will get it too, but I'm trying to channel you towards Patreon because that's a big part of the support you give, and it's very, very important. You guys get extra content. Yesterday you got a 21-minute video of Resorts World, and this week you'll get like 25 minutes of a Fremont Street tour that looks like you're there in real life. Donald John wants to, who wants to go out on Fresh and Sexy? Somebody asked here, says, Louie, do you gamble? I don't gamble, Louie. I'm one of the few that don't. So people think at this point I'm putting down other channels. I'm not. But when Vegas was in the pandemic stage and then it came out of it, everybody found their niche, right? So, but some of their niches dried up. So think about this, right? If you review fast food hamburgers, you think when you start reviewing fast food hamburgers that you can do your channel forever, and if people really like you reviewing them, you're set, right? You're set. You can review the Big Mac, the quarter pounder, the double quarter pounder, the double Big Mac. You can review anything at McDonald's, Wendy's, Burger King. You can travel to other regions, but eventually you'll eat all of the fast food hamburgers in the country and then there's no more. So you can either revisit all that, or you can do new content, right? New, not nude, new content. I almost said, like I said, nude. So what happened with these channels, God bless them, was a lot of them said during the pandemic, oh, I don't do gambling videos. I'm not a gambler. Well, wouldn't you know it, they're all doing gambling videos. I think, in my opinion, for me, it's because the thing that they were doing that was working really well stopped working and they needed new content. And you guys love gambling videos, a lot of you. So they're filling a void and helping themselves support their families by doing gambling videos. And so that's what I think happened. I always said I don't gamble, and it's true, I don't gamble. I don't like it. I know that I have addictions and I don't want that to become one of them. For me, not for them, for me. So I don't do it. Anyways, let's go inside of, this is the Pepper Club here, and we're gonna go, so you should check out Pepper Club if you're here. It's a big lineup to get in right now. Let's just walk through it real fast. So, excuse me, guy with the camera coming through. I'm not trying to be a jerk, I promise. So they have the outdoor seating out here. Pretty amazing. You got the fire pits going on, covered seating. They actually have a big bay window that can open up on the other side if they want to. And this is a 5-star chef taught English, Michelin, I think. Excuse me. I'm gonna sneak past you. I'm so sorry. So this is Pepper Club inside. They have lots of stuff on the menu. This is a lot of Pacific Asian fare. It's an open kitchen concept, so you can see them in the back doing their thing, which is pretty cool. It's always crazy busy down here. Really nice kitchen, really nice staff. Really great service. The food is fantastic. I had somebody from the channel that watches the channel take us here once, and we did a consultation. I do YouTube consulting. I did it for a fee for them. We sat at literally one of these tables on the right. You got the bar in between. So if you're looking for a really nice restaurant that's not in a casino where you don't have to walk through a smoky casino to get to it, this is one of those places that you should definitely go to. Was that Chloe? I don't think there's any celebrities in here today. Hey, how's it going? I think it's changed a lot. It did change a lot. It did. Where's Coach? Coach is our manager here, Steve Dennis, Cash or Crash. He's got a YouTube channel. Well, kids, we crushed another 3 hours here on the stream today. That's crazy. Oh, Chloe works at the English. I don't know them by name. I should get to know them by name. I'm down here long enough, darn it. So that's cool. Wowza. The Park MGM is smoke-free. Yeah, that's the only one. As construction started on the train, they say they're doing right-of-way things. So they have to do. They're building a train between Vegas and Los Angeles, but it's not really Los Angeles. It's actually the valley. So the train will run from, can't remember, one of the little suburbs out to Vegas. And they say that it'll take, you know, a couple hours to get here, but it'll be faster than driving, which is probably true. At the same time, they say it'll cost $400, which is preposterous. They have the land, plug my phone in, they have the land, they have all of the money, and they say they're gonna start building it. Now, they are building the terminal in Vegas by the outlet centers on the south end of the strip. Whether or not that ever happens is a whole nother thing. It's called Brightline West. And Brightline Express is running trains in Florida right now, but I got a dent in my head, I do. They're running trains in Florida, but they've never turned a profit. Vinyl asked me if I'm a Crip. Yeah, Crips wear blue. I just went with the New York motif today because I finally have all my clothes in one spot with the help of my wife who's been cleaning up the house and unpacking stuff still. So, you know, but right away doesn't mean snatching up properties in this case, because they're actually running it parallel to the Interstate 15. So they just have to go along Interstate 15 and grade the ground, and then they have to lay the tracks and everything like that. So we'll see if that ever comes to pass. Again, I don't know that it ever will. I think there's a chance that it doesn't happen. But they got a lot of money from the Biden administration to do that. Unfortunately, a lot of the money that went to the cities went to other places, you know, like up in Illinois, a lot of the money they got from the Biden administration for COVID recovery went to programs to house newcomers, as they call them nowadays, and stuff like that. So the people that are here that came in over the border on the south end up there, and then they give the money to other places. So I don't know where California put their newcomer money. I don't know, but I know that the city and the state of Nevada and Vegas and Clark County gave them all the bonds they wanted. The big challenge was getting bonds from California, and they couldn't get the financing. Progress video would be cool, but right now there's nothing there except for a chain link fence, and I think the banners are even gone now. They had them up, but they didn't put wind cutouts in them, so I think they got ripped off, because I was down in that area the other day. And there's really no sign of anything. It's just a plot of dirt land across the street from the outlet center. So we got that. The video this week is going to be about Fountain Blue and their filming policy and kicking me out of the property, and what you guys should do if you're actually approached by a security guard. I'm going to have to do some research on the laws on that kind of stuff in Vegas, because I think they have every right to ask you for your ID, but I don't think you have to surrender it. But I know that I can't ever go back to Fountain Blue, because I have now been 86th out of Fountain Blue, and I have the receipts to show it, which is very strange, because, you know, I've been in Vegas for 20 years and been doing this channel for 5, and I've never encountered anything like that before in my entire 20-year time. And I gotta point out, for 2007 to 2020, for 13 of those years, I worked on the strip. I never had any problems. Well, I was at 86. Well, we did a live stream on Friday, and I was showing the convention center on the third, fourth, fifth, and sixth floors. And when I came down the escalator to the main area, there was a guard that was waiting for me. And he demanded my ID, and I said no, because I know what happens if they demand the ID. What happens is this. They look at your ID. They read it to the security detail. They give them your driver's license number. And then they give them your name and your date of birth. And then they read off of a card or off of their smartphone the NRS law on trespassing. And they say that you had been officially trespassed from the Fountain Blue and all of its affiliate companies worldwide. And if you ever come back, hey, what's up? You want to be on my camera?
Not really.
Okay. Well, you did for a minute. You did this. All right. Then they tell you that if you ever come back, you're going to go to jail. There you go. Where did I work on the strip? I worked a lot of places on the strip. I was a renegade timeshare guy, so back when timeshare wasn't what it is today, it was a lot simpler and less predatory. I worked in front of the Planet Hollywood, the Bellagio. I worked in front of the Treasure Island. I worked in front of the Mirage. I worked in front of the Flamingo. I worked in front of what's now the new Boulevard, which used to be Hawaii Marketplace. I worked down near New York, New York. I worked on Fremont Street. I worked in a lot of places. Oh, I guess they let Pompsy film at Fountain Blue. Okay. I suppose so. So they didn't like me, but they liked Pompsy. That's good. If me and Caroline went to Fountain Blue without a camera, would I be okay? Probably. I mean, I wouldn't show up looking like this. I'd do my hair. I'd wear nicer clothing. They probably wouldn't even know it was me. That's why you don't give them your ID. But you know, who knows? Maybe they have really cool video surveillance that'll match my gait and my facial recognition. Who knows? Who cares? I like Fountain Blue's architecture. I hate Fountain Blue's style. I think it's exclusionary. And I think it's there for elitists. And look, if you want a piece of the high life, I would recommend the Wynn, the Encore, the Venetian, the Palazzo, or the Bellagio, or Caesar's Palace. There's a 7 or 8 properties that are not looking down on you because you don't have the money that they want you to have. So they insist you for filming without permission. Well, I wasn't filming, I was live streaming. Yeah, it was just a really intense situation. I just never had that much intensity come off a guard before. It was just kind of strange. So yeah, let's see here. La 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 la. My brother Rob used to sell timeshares in front of the Westwood. I never heard of the Westwood. AI security in the future will they already recognize your face, Dutch. Yeah, actually, the plaza downtown, which we went through today, they have a system called Sentry, I think it's called Sentry. And Sentry is like scary. They installed it during COVID-19. And what it does is actually looks for symptoms of COVID-19. and it actually looks for, so what they do is your face is unique. It's like a fingerprint, right? My nose is a little crooked here and my eyes are a certain offsets and my ears are not, nobody's ears are the same, and it triangulates your face. And then even if you wore a mask, a lot of the security systems, what they do is they build a wireframe of your body. So you imagine there's a wire running here, and there's two dots here, and then there's another wire, and there's a dot, and there's a dot. And so then your hips have two dots. That's how you draw stuff, by the way. You draw a circle and a line, and then a wire, circles, lines, these are the arms, these are the hands. And then the hips are a triangle, and there's two hips, which are circles. Down there, your knees are circles, your ankles are circles, and your feet are triangles. And it actually measures your gait, because everybody's walks a little bit different. So it can recognize you based on how you walk, you know? He said, don't come back. He didn't say, don't ever come back. That's a good point too, Martin D. I like your style. I like the way you use that. Martin D, you should be an attorney in a court of law. Smart stuff, what you said just now. That's true too. So yeah, but then you have the exact polar opposite. You have the English Hotel. You're right now at at the start of this stream. This is how the English Hotel rolls with YouTubers. So if you really like your YouTubers, consider where you're staying. So today I came in, tried to park, they have free parking, the parking was filled. So I went back to First Street, which is right here. And I said to the front desk, can I park on First Street? Peter Faulkner, thank you for 79 pence. Appreciate you. That's over a dollar US. Thank you for the super chat, Peter. And 921 Main Street English Hotel. And I said, can I park here? And then the lady said, I don't know, ask the security guard. So I asked the security guard, his name was Jose, and his English was pretty good, but then he spoke better Spanish. So he asked her, and then they had a Spanish conversation, and I'm trying to pick it up. I'm like, what are they saying? What is this all about? What is this? Did they say? And then he walks me out here and he opens up a spot that I didn't even know that they owned. He takes a pylon away, says you can park here anytime. You're a YouTuber and you're a friend of Steve Dennis. Hello. That's the opposite of what the Fountain Blue is doing. That's pretty cool. I like that. I think that's a really good way of doing business. Welcome people in. This battery charger is dead. My battery's at 10%, so I have to go. Stay tuned to the channel. We're gonna have a regular upload on Thursday. If you're on Patreon or channel memberships, please consider joining Patreon. It's as low as 16 cents a day. It's $5 a month. You can't buy a cup of coffee nowadays for that from a Starbucks in most cases, unless you want a basic plain Jane. But you'll get extra content. You can cancel at any time, unless you want to buy a year in advance and you get a discount. I have video of this security guard interaction, JBID. So consider that. You'll get an extra video this week. I posted one just yesterday, so you already have 21 minutes of 4K beautiful footage from the new camera. And you guys are fantastic. And Fountain Blue wanted investors and ended up having crap over MBNA. You guys are wonderful. English Hotel is great. This place is very friendly. It's a boutique hotel with less than 80 rooms. They'll know your name like Cheers. When you walk in, they'll say, Norm! Unless your name is not Norm. I love you guys. God bless you all. Have a great Palm Sunday. 3, 2, 1, click.